If I remember correctly, we left off with you guys leaving to venture to a different part of town in your quest to explore.
Explore.
Talk.
Explore.
Explore.
You should give us the map picture.
I'm working on it right now.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, it still has our little doodles on it. That's good.
Well, they'd be
Yes.
bad if it didn't.
So we checked the cemetery.
Hello.
Kiala,
There you
welcome
are.
back. We just started, so you didn't miss
Okay.
anything.
Cool.
Beep.
So, beep. We checked the cemetery.
Yep.
We put Arthur on task. He's not happy with us.
Arthur and Nat, they're both watching the cemetery.
Yes.
Cool.
So we're just gonna go like that, I guess.
Continue with patrol.
And
So,
Henderson's like, beep,
oh.
beep. Drive it along.
So where do you guys patrol to next, then?
We have one in the residential area. But where's the residential? Is it like along the Green Hill Elm area?
The residential area is this area, I do
Oh.
believe. Let me check my original map.
Bop, bop.
Doo-doo.
Bop.
Oh, I forgot left the O behind. I'm sorry.
Yes,
I apologize to you.
the residential area is this area.
Theo just has to run behind the van.
Completely forgot we have a tank in our vehicle.
That's
how he
his
works
punishment.
out.
It's his punishment for making a bad joke. He has to run behind the van.
So, you guys drive down to the residential area. Tomo, you remember the residential area. You remember those good old days when you came over here and sat in the middle of the road at like 3 a.m.
Oh, right. Forgot I did that. Whoops.
So you come in.
Beep beep.
Roll a perception.
All of us.
Boop. You guys are just driving in the car right now.
I should make those so they auto re-roll.
You should.
There was something kind of charming
Oh
about
my
re-rolling my
God.
own tens, but it's much easier.
Yeah.
Something self-indulgent about rerolling.
Yeah.
Why? It's like all my rolls are terrible at the beginning of session, and then once the session starts getting into it more, I start getting better rolls. What is
Nice.
this?
The dad is perceptive, which is good
Oh.
because he's driving.
Use your
Oh.
dad eyes.
Wait, sorry.
What do you see with your dad eyes?
Oh.
Henderson sees the
Oh.
road.
That's good. Good.
That's good. That's what
Is
you
the
should be
road of
seeing.
champions.
All right, tell about your successes, please. What time did I say it was last session?
Like three, I think.
Three? I thought so. Okay, so it's three. Tomo, memory lane right here. Bunker Hill Drive. Oh, you remember just trying to walk into that lady's house.
To be fair, he still thought it was a dream, but whatever.
Still.
He still did try and get into someone's house.
There's still dream politeness, all right?
Theo, you're looking around and you're trying to locate the area. You remember the general area in which you guys set up the clock was like over here-ish.
Close to the chapel.
Yes, close to the chapel.
Cool.
Sal and Lemons, you guys are approaching, you're getting near the clock. Figuring, hey, gonna check that out. It's gonna be good. There's the clock.
That's the good
Hey!
shit right there.
It's Gucci, man. And you notice there's not really a lot of people out today. Usually you got people hustling and bustling around residential area, but either they've already hustled and they're going to bustle later, or they're just not out today. It is kind of overcast, you'd notice. And some pretty thick clouds have been coming on since cemetery.
Huh. I will make a conclusion of later bustling.
Henderson, you notice all this. You also see the clock perfectly hidden in the trees. You remember putting it there. And you pull over, you know, see everything. Looks great, man. Yeah, there's nothing more. Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. then you're dead. Like, I just...
You got four successes, not five, my boy.
Okay, the eagle's not here yet.
Should we briefly drive by the Albrechts and see, make sure everything looks all right over there?
I assume we'll go all the way down here.
They left Theophilus running towards down the truck. There
too, yeah.
Yeah. Well, they did say to sweep the perimeter, and they're like on the outskirts of the perimeter. Mm-hmm. So we may as well. Beep, beep.
Well, that's Jaredias over there. Albrechts was,
Well, I mean, we're just going in a circle.
Yeah.
Oh, did we? Oh,
we forgot to go over here.
That's the map hasn't completely loaded for me yet, so it's still all pixely.
Oh, no.
So I can't read it.
Oh, yeah, this area is residential.
Yes.
The road you were on was the one that led straight to Jaredias.
And it only has one singular house, and that's Jaredias.
Yeah.
But we should definitely check that out.
Yeah.
Mm.
I don't know why we haven't set up a clock down there. I mean, he's pretty... Or, well, he's not there anymore, but it's pretty out of the way.
Okay. You guys drive past and... go down to Albrecht Dentistry. Despite everyone not hustling or bustling, they are in fact open.
Yeah. Okay. I don't suppose we need to go in. We're just
making Should we sure. perception?
If you'd like to, yes.
Ooh.
Why not?
Three. Oh, right. I forgot. I have.
Oh my god.
The Albrecht's house, so I can just pull that up for you. I forget I have pictures sometimes. Oh, come on, Chrome, don't do this to me. It's being rude. I got it just in time. Alright, tell about your successes, please.
One.
Wait, oh, whoops, my bad.
I'll be honest, I never know how to spell any of the German stuff, I just know how to pronounce it.
Mm-hmm. Zwei is with a Z.
That's true.
Alright, yes.
It's been a while.
Retype, please, because Sal.
Sal ruined it.
I'm sorry.
We forgive you.
Do we?
Just kidding, we don't.
Mm. Pay attention, you poopy head.
I wonder if he got his window fixed.
All right, you guys, Tomo, you can come in here and you just really don't like this area. It feels like you're being watched all the time, probably because it's pretty much in the woods and you don't have very good relations with the woods. It's a house, though. It's definitely Albrecht Dentistry. Did they get a new sign? Maybe. It looks kind of nice. Lemons and Henderson, you guys see that... They definitely did a little bit of slight fixing upping, including the window, which is now fixed.
Hooray.
Yes, that is in fact a new sign.
Oh.
And you notice the car is parked in the parking lot. You recognize it as Reese's, though you do not notice his waifu's car.
She's out at work.
Theo and Sal.
Yes, hello.
You guys see all this, and... You know, it seems pretty natural. You notice a couple, what seems to be animal tracks around on the floor. Deer.
Can I survive? Oh, okay, never mind.
You want
Can I survival to make sure they're deer?
You may.
Oh. All right, what is that, wit survival?
That is wit survival.
Oh, my son.
Smells it.
You look at these deer prints and you see the little thing and the thingy and that's definitely a deer.
All right.
I am Sal, the deer expert, and I can confirm this is a deer.
This is definitely not a sheep's. It's just a deer.
Well, it might be a deer that walks on 2 feet.
Kind of like a wounded.
Oh, I don't know what you're talking about.
Wait, is it like four? Is it in pairs of four? Isn't that a survivey thing you look at?
You can make another survival check.
I will. Double the... All right, no, forget it. Forget I said anything. I'm sure that would have been a great thing to notice. My dice didn't want to.
Sal, you're getting closer and closer, and then you're like... Yeah, these are definitely deer. Get up. Just, I don't care.
Hey, I want Lemons to kind of like... You know, it'll slide over and be like, "Hey, Sal, what you looking at?" And just look at it. Too.
Okay, you may.
Wait, here's the face. Here's the face that Sal gives you. This is the exact face that he gives you.
I have no survival. So what's this roll?
So it's still a wit survival.
Aw, yeah. Oh my god, yes.
A stern Sal glare.
Oh my god, is it what
I think it
is?
Critically failed.
Oh. You're bending over to look at this, Lemons, and you're like, "Oh, I'm so excited to look at these." But as you do, you lose your center of gravity.
Oh no.
And you fall, and because Reese is on a hill, you tumble through all the tracks and accidentally erase them.
Sal will lean down and be like, "What are you doing there?"
Oh my god, did I just do that?
Oh no.
Lemons,
oh my god,
you
Lemons.
Okay over there?
No, I'm not. I had too much to drink. I'm sorry, guys. I've disappointed us all.
It's 3 in the afternoon.
You've been drinking at 3 in the afternoon?
Was that in character?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh my god.
He gets up and starts dusting himself off.
Everyone is just like, it's 3 in the afternoon.
He just gets up and dusts himself off.
Well, I didn't do that.
No, I didn't do that. Just wipe that from your memory, guys, okay? I gotta keep this cool guy thing going, okay?
Sal will look at him and say, no.
Oh my god.
Unless you wanna ask him if you've seen anything strange, we could probably go.
Reese, what has your wandering eye seen?
Oh, we remember how well that went last time. We got stuck for like an hour not having lemonade.
Yeah, we can go. I mean, you didn't tell us the canvas people, I guess, so.
Maybe we should leave him alone.
Everyone bails out.
Leave me alone.
Roll a perception, everyone.
Oh boy.
Oh, here he comes.
Ow. Holy shit.
Ooh, Jesus, Sal.
Sal.
Hello.
Let me re-roll all four of those real quick.
There's your
eagle. Dang it!
Well, you get a wild eagle, I guess.
An eagle that flies in that slams into a wall.
quickly, before he notices we're here.
All right, type. Okay. Tomo and Lemons, you're too focused on what Lemons just did just now. What a wipeout. You guys see a new little smudge on his nice tan jacket.
Oh, fuck.
Did he actually say that? Oh my god.
Like, I hope you didn't really care about you falling, and then you see the smudge, and you're like, ah, shit,
man.
It's literally shit.
Oh, no.
He's trying to hold in tears.
He's like, no, it's mine. I swear.
A Henderson.
Yes.
It's... You're really focused. You know, you kind of want to get back to the car, and so you're looking back in that direction. And it's just... You try to not mention the fact that Lemons has more than one smudge, and one of them's wine.
legends of Bad Axe.
Yeah, he's not gonna mention that.
Lemons, please.
And you're keeping an eye on the Albert house, you know, maybe not wanting too much grease to everyone contact right now.
If he remembers, the wife doesn't like him.
Does he, or if he?
He does.
Oh, okay. I was confused for a second.
Unless I need roll to see if he...
No. I thought you phrased it as a question. I was like, I don't care.
I don't care.
Ouch.
I don't care about your problem.
Look, man, I'm just a GM.
Theo, you turn along with Sal in time to see what seems to be a figure walking towards you down the long road from the residential area. And Sal, with your fantastic view, you can see it seems to be a thin, small girl, black hair. And an eagle flies by, blotting out the sun just for a moment. And not only do you catch her face, and you can actually roll a, I'd say a wit streetwise to see if you recognize her from hearsay.
All right, time to roll all of my street rise.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's pretty. There's one.
And also, the eagle flies past you, overhead. You feel like this is the one you had a dominance battle before, and now he works for you.
He is my son.
The one that you saw out in the woods.
Oh my god.
And he flies overhead and lands. And you look over at where he lands. And you find the continuation of the deer tracks.
My god. Can I look at them and can I try survival again?
Well, before that, I'm going to give you some details on this girl you see. Since you made a streetwise.
I did, yes.
So, you're looking at her and... You know, you don't talk to people much here, but you can recognize this girl. I mean, not to be racist, but I mean, aside from Tomo, she's like one of the only Asians in town.
Carlsville is small.
I don't think.
And you know she works. Oh, where does she work? That roadhouse place is a. Yeah, you think you've seen her come from there before with the little uniform and stuff. Oh, but her name. You just don't know the name, though.
Okay. So, Sal will, first of all, he will salute the eagle, and then... And then he will go to the tracks. I want to try survival one more time.
You may try survival. Casual reminder, y'all.
What you just saw.
He'll point her out later. He has more important things. He knows how to.
Casual reminder, y'all still have willpower.
Silly.
All right.
Who needs that?
Now we're banking it.
So, unless it gets real. This time the tracks don't elude you. You know where they're going. You got it.
Yes. Finally.
And they're leading up. It looks like they're winding through the woods, but still leading up Residential Street, opposite of Reese's house.
Wait, they're going towards the people?
Yes.
Okay, well, Sal will first of all be like, look, it's the lady from the steakhouse. But not like, obviously not like that. And then he will...
Like that.
And then he'll be like, also, these deer things are going towards... Can I remember anything deer-related, as in Wendigo, as in deer-related?
You may roll either an Wits Occult or a Memory, so Intelligence Composure.
I think I'm going to go ahead and do a Wits Occult. That's 5. Wowzers. They're both 5. Wow. Dang it. Okay. So what kind of information do I get from Occult, and what kind of information do I get from Memory?
Memory is stuff you've experienced. Occult is stuff you've read.
Okay, well, I'm going to do Memory, because... There's something I've actually read, and I don't know if there's other deer things I don't want to deal with.
All right.
Spookies.
You're trying to remember, and you're like, well, yeah, Reese. Then you have flashback memories of all the freaking taxidermy in Reese's house, and you're like, there are deer in this area.
All right, so...
And then there was that also that thing what was that thing? That the Liz's house, something about a thing that wind and stuff. I don't know.
This L is a good.
I'm actually gonna. Wait, he knows what a Wendigo is, though. So if you, all right. So
you can have Sel connect the points if you want.
Okay, because like wind or something. The only creature I know with wind. The thing I've been suspicious about for Levins.
It's the eagle.
It's the eagle. I knew it. I knew you left deer tracks.
The eagle's eyes shine bright red as it goes into the sun.
As the light reflects off the eagle, he has a giant hoof in the middle of his chest. Oh my! All right. Anyways, Sal first he'll be like, "Oh, it's a girl from the steakhouse, or it's the roadhouse."
Sal's just thinking about steaks.
He's hungry. And he's like, "Wait, there's deer tracks going towards the village. I'm so done right now. There's deer tracks going towards the residential area." And then he's like, but then the deer, there's a lot of deer things. And then he looks at Lemon and he's like, oh yeah. And he's saying this, by the way. He's definitely talking out loud. And then he's like,
oh my God.
And then he's like, is it and he's pointing at Lemon, so he's trying to finish it.
Lemons was for a while distracted by the mention of steak, and then he just kind of stares at Sal making all the gestures at him.
What's going on over here?
Deer tracks. Okay. Going towards the residential area.
What's going on here? Deer tracks.
Well, there's
Sal is
deer
not really
in the area.
But yeah,
there is a lot of deer. Theo will point out, oh, someone's coming up the walkway.
Lemon tries to make himself look presentable.
Roll to be present.
What am I rolling to present?
Present.
Presence and whatever you dang well please.
Composure.
Everything.
Composure. Yes, presence and composure sounds actually perfect.
Oh my God, yes. I'm going to add striking looks onto there too because I'm beautiful.
Okay.
Three.
I am beautiful.
Yeah, please, while you're there.
You do this
no matter what you say. Sorry.
You do like in... One second.
Do like a hair flip with...
It's like yeah, you get up in a hair flip, but you also do like the coat flip.
Yes.
Where like you put it behind you so that they can't see it.
Pop the collar. Cool shit. Lemons is presentable mode.
They have it in like half the epic rap battles of history where they just like flip the coat behind them.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Just, this is the closest I can get of it, so. The little Beethoven's in the background.
Yes.
I love how you use that as an example. It's great.
It's what first came to mind. And
how do you even think of, like, how old is that? You were like, oh yeah, years. Epic rack battles. That's the one.
That's the one right there.
Anyway.
That's it.
So you do it, Lemons. You feel like you are presentable.
Yes, good.
All your stains are hidden in your ego. And she comes close enough to you where you think she'd be in of earshot. Here's a picture of her. And you see her, see you guys, and slowly walk to the other side of the road.
She just nopes away from
and
the weirdos.
It's pretty much a gravel path at this point, so...
Hey, we just want to...
You need to, like, turn right? sideways and do the awkward, like... Do we go chest to chest, or chest to butt, or butt to butt?
When do you turn away from someone when they're walking by you? That's not what happens.
No, like when it's too narrow, so you have to turn to your side to like squeeze past someone.
Well, it's not super. It's like a wide gravel path.
okay.
Like,
I was just joking, but
it's like driveway.
Yeah, like see picture.
Lemons just gets all neighborly, which is just smiling and doing the neighborly wave.
You give a neighborly wave, Lemons, and you get a moment of awkward eye contact before she just kind of gives a curt nod and breaks eye contact. And
she's not dealing with us.
No.
And she seems to be coming towards you guys.
Well, we are by the dentist. Maybe she wants perfect teeth. I know.
Well, they are the only dentists in town.
Maybe we should let her do her thing.
Stop her!
Sal comes running out of the woods.
Yeah. High kicks her in the head.
Eagle in hand. Go, my son.
Fires the eagle out of his jacket.
God. Deploy eagle.
Do we know, are you suspicious of the deer track, Sal? Sorry. Henderson's like also ignoring her because he also doesn't want to talk.
Wait, what did he say again?
He's asking if they're suspicious of deer tracks, Sal.
Okay, so this was kind of a hard question to answer. Because on one hand, they are just kind of deer tracks. Did I notice that they were, like, in pairs?
Nope.
Or okay, so no, they're just deer tracks. the only thing I noticed is that I remembered Wendigo is kind of like a deer. So Sal will just be like, well, these tracks, like, themselves, the only suspicious thing about them is that they're going towards the village, towards the residential area. But the only other deer-related thing I could think of, besides deers, is the Wendigo that we, Lemons.
Oh, Henderson looks up towards the sky. Aren't those supposed to be accompanied by, storms?
Hey, guys.
Did I...
Hey.
Hmm? Theo points helpfully.
Yeah, she is kind of walking past us.
Well, I thought she had already walked like past us.
She was walking towards you and is currently passing you.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Then he probably would have waited to bring that up.
Sal wouldn't have, though.
Well, Sal didn't. Yeah, he thought he was just being dumb for like all these years until Henderson asked him about it. Sal will wave at the friend.
Goodbye, friend.
She just, since she's close enough where she can't pretend she didn't see you.
Sal smile.
Oh no.
She just.
You found another lady to pursue, Sal.
What? Come on!
raises hand. Morning.
Morning.
Is it morning?
Afternoon now, I think.
Oh. Sal actually asks, is it morning?
And she just kind of looks up while still kind of walking away.
Squints up the sky.
Yeah.
Afternoon.
Are you heading towards the dentist's?
Yes.
Okay. Good luck.
She narrows her eyebrows.
She narrows her eyebrows?
Like, you know, kind of like
furrows her brow.
Furrows her brows. Yeah. Narrows eyes, furrows brows.
Yes.
You know how Reese can be. So, Lemons is gonna step in and try to save this sinking conversation.
He's a lifeguard for conversation.
Oh my god.
And she just kind of looks confused.
You know, the whole just overtly friendly. No.
Why would that need luck?
So you don't get netted into couple-hour conversation. And he smiles.
You know, no cavities. Good.
Henderson's still trying.
Well, he feels like he's a part of the conversation now.
And then she just, when you say no cavities, it seems click, and it's like, oh yeah. Yes, cavities.
Henderson's the one who saved the day.
Well, we'll best be on our way. I'm just gonna try to hurt everyone.
Are you new here?
We've been here for a little bit.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. I'm Guy. He offers a hand.
Just right over Henderson.
She shakes her hand. Megumi.
Ah, Megumi. Can I make a memory check to figure out where she works if I heard from Gloria?
Sure.
Okay, that's resolve composure, right?
Yeah. Not resolve composure, no. Intelligence composure. Intelligence.
Thank you.
Oh my god.
Sal, one baby please. Success.
Somewhere involving food.
The most important.
That's all lemons cares about,
pretty much.
I think that's the most basic lemons.
I don't think we've met before.
Be.
I know I've been trying to get around town, but I don't think I've gotten around to where you work. He just kind of trawls off a little bit.
No.
Are you new?
And she shakes her head. I've been here for a couple of years now.
Ah.
Yeah. She just kind of like turns and raises hand, quick like wave thing, continues towards the dentist.
Aww. Cute.
Emma just waves as she goes. And when she's gone, that wasn't awkward at all.
I was trying to be friendly.
Sal will say that wasn't awkward at all.
Jesus Christ.
Lemons, oh my god, stop.
The theory is true about you with Henderson.
Stop giving Henderson so much crap. Poor Henderson.
He's just a dad.
What, that Lemons like literally just walks all over?
Yes. Oh my god.
He is literally the person his nice persona is crafted for, and he drops it when.
Because Henderson won't say shit about it.
That's such a good point.
But then one day, Henderson will be like, this is enough.
Let's be honest here. Lemon's persona is for people he meets here and there. These are the people he lives with. It's really hard to keep something like that up.
Telling me.
Anyways, if you guys want to do anything.
Adventure.
Oh, I think.
Follow the deer
and
track.
Back towards the.
Wait, no. Henderson said the storm thing, and we didn't even follow up on that.
What?
Oh. That. Yeah. When Wendigos show up.
Yeah, that conversation should probably be continued now.
Well, I mean, it's overcast, but it doesn't seem very stormy.
I think we should still be careful.
I guess we could try to find where they come back out, if they come back out.
Sure.
So they go out of the woods and then up towards the residential area?
No, they loop around the back, I think she said. Like, in the woods still, just back towards the town or whatever.
Oh.
Bree?
Yes?
Okay, I was making sure you weren't muted.
No, I listen. I'm listening to you guys.
I'm worried about you. I don't want that mute thing to happen again.
Oh no.
Oh yeah, that was a really sad day.
When like three different people accidentally muted themselves.
Then Bree was just, why are you guys ignoring me?
It was a sad day.
It was very sad.
So what do we do now?
Whatever.
Except
you
what
want.
You guys
want
to
do.
I mean, Sal is in this situation. He has nothing to punch, so he could use the follow.
punch a tree.
Sal punches a tree.
Don't actually punch a tree.
Maybe.
Why would you suggest that if you didn't expect him to follow through?
Maybe we should continue. Instead of loitering in front of the dentist's house like creepers.
Yeah.
A bunch of weirdos. I mean,
yeah.
Gosh, what a bunch of weirdos.
Weirdos.
Look out, Flapjack. That guy's a weirdo.
Get out of here.
I don't think just deer tracks are that alarming, but, I mean, if you're really concerned. Can he roll to see if Wendigo is always accompanied by, like, a storm? Like, it's always, like, storming, or whether it can be just overcast Wendigo?
A
less powerful Wendigo.
What would you like to roll for that?
A cult, I assume?
Oh, yeah, sure. I thought you were asking for a memory. I was like, that ain't no memory.
I mean, unless it was something you remembered with the...
You did read a Wendigo book, though, didn't you?
Yeah. Yes, yeah, you did.
I suppose you could do either, though.
He got a 2.
I mean, his memory is 6 instead of 5, so we'll roll both in. Okay, well, he got a 2 on his occult roll.
Okay, you're thinking about it, and it's not always, but commonly.
Okay, so it's just like... Yeah, it's not like a set thing for... Oops, sorry.
It's fine.
I cut out.
They usually have control of it, from what you understand.
Okay. I guess it can't hurt to help out to check it out. Sal, can you tell where they're leading?
I can try and find out. More. So
can we just follow the tracks?
It will take a survival roll.
I will do that.
Can Henderson assist?
You may. But I don't think he needs you.
He's probably not gonna.
You got pretty good.
We roll those 2, Sal. Oh, we already did.
Yeah.
Okay. Did. Together you'll 5. Sal.
Wait, never mind. That is crit. Never mind.
It isn't a technical crit. The eagle isn't gonna show his face for you.
Well, usually how an assist works is they roll their roll and then they add however many successes onto the dice pool.
Oh yeah.
So Sal's to roll.
Forgot about.
Wait, what?
You have 2 more dice to roll, Sal.
Oh, reroll that 10. Oh, wait, no, you already have the thing. Okay, never mind.
Because Henderson's adding his successes turn into dice that you roll.
Okay.
Swift.
I am not an equal child.
Have we been doing it wrong then?
Yes.
It's up to the GM, like, it's not that important.
Sorry, dealing with something quick.
I feel like you have very similar results, so.
Cat. Did you add the 2 dice?
Yes. So it's 4.
4 successes?
For okay. Sal, yeah. It's all like, right. At one point he loses them and Henderson's like, there they are, and he sounds like, oh, thanks.
Well, I mean, you find, as you follow, they don't actually lead nearly as far away as you thought. You weave in between trees, and you eventually come to the outside of the church.
It's Jesus.
Nani.
This just in, Jesus was the Wendigo the whole time.
Turns around, Wendigo has Jesus beard.
Where Wendigo?
Do you have a moment to talk about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ?
And so...
What is a were Wendigo?
Turns into a Wendigo on the full moon! Jesus!
It's so simple.
It's a were-wendigo. He's a where-to-go. Where did he come from? Go. When did he go?
What is wrong with
God
you
damn it.
Shark, you better quote that.
When did he go?
Yeah, hi, Shark. Hello.
So,
Shark, quote this, please.
You guys come up basically from the woods behind the church. And it's... You've been wandering around. I'd say it's probably about, like, 350, going on 4.
Boom. We should...
Henderson gave... Theo the keys to bring the cart with them. Since he's out helping.
Okay. What? So Theo, you have keys.
Oh god.
Okay.
Unless he's not comfortable, then he can give them to Lemons.
Why is Theo driving now?
Because Henderson's helping track, so he can't be in the car, and he doesn't want to just leave the car outside of Reese's place.
Oh, did we drive that far up? I thought we got out and walked.
Well, I assumed we drove part of the, at least part of the way.
Lemons can take it if Theo doesn't want it. Sure. Okay. There you go. So, Lemons just admitted to having too much wine before 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Nice, fine, guys.
He takes out 4 wine. Shut up, Theo!
Yeah, you guys come back in the RV and you see him, like, his feet kicked up and he's drinking more.
He's god.
Chugging from the bottle. Hey.
I'm drunk driving. I'm totally drunk.
This is totally responsible.
He's totally responsible. Yeah.
Anyways, following the tracks to the church.
Lemons goes and wanders back to the RV.
You wander and find the RV, it's a miracle.
Oh my god, I found it. Theo will bring car.
And you bring car, you guys end up in front of the church.
He has to, like, super readjust the seat because Henderson is big and he is not.
He big.
I was gonna ask if your little feeties can even get the pedals.
He has to move the seat, like, all the way up.
And so, you arrive, and you are all in front of the church. It's pretty much... It's in a very decrepit state. Roll of perceptions.
Are we keeping in someone, like, am I keeping Lemons in the RV in case we need to ollie out?
Whoa!
Hey, Tomo woke up.
Wow!
Hey.
At like 4 in the afternoon.
Does Lemons want to hang out in the RV and keep watch? Because I thought Henderson was going to do that, but then he came with us to walk around the houses. It'll be Lemons' turn to keep an eye out. Okay. So you can chill in the RV. Yeah, so the Dooble doesn't always have to stay behind.
Okay.
And drink a bunch of wine.
Type out your successes. Lemons, since you're not too far away, you can do 1, 2 if you see good.
Hey, Sal, come on. We together. We both have 4.
He had an appropriate roll.
Alright. Lemons, I'm in an RV. This is a church. Whatever.
Why is he
suddenly Valley Girl?
That's drunk Lemons, don't you know?
you hear the subtle sound of a pop of a cork in the distance.
Oh my god.
Oh no.
Lemons, please. Henderson,
you're gonna kill us all.
You know this church has been here for a while. You've seen it on your jogs and stuff, but it's just... You never paid much attention to it.
Okay.
It just wasn't super important to you. But you remember it. You remember it in this decrepit state, but usually the doors were closed. This go around, they are creaked open. Theo, you also noticed this.
Mm-hmm.
And then Tomo and Sal. You guys notice all the above. You notice the deer tracks leading up to it. And you hear something.
What do we hear?
What do you hear? Give me a second. I'm going to adjust the...
You just hear a noise. Indescribable noise. An eldritch horror.
Hear a murloc in the distance.
Yep, that's it. Freaking murloc comes out of nowhere and clotheslines you.
Rip entire Cardians team.
We're all dead.
Rip.
Huh?
Sounds like fly, dead body.
Tomo's gonna go investigate this.
Cream. I will also investigate this. Who would join the tomes? Oh, actually, no. Sal pointed out first, so they're not like, where are they going? Yes. Hey guys, there's fly noises. Maybe something is rotting over here.
Want to see a dead body?
Oh, jeez.
Think we should take a look in?
Sorry, we walked in with.
Oh,
yeah, he's going. Tumble's going in. Yeah.
God damn it! That was mostly addressed to Henderson, anyway. Apparently, you motherfuckers are just wandering off.
I feel like that's how Tomo. Angie is how Tomo thinks, or Theo thinks.
Pretty much.
Tomo and Sal are going inside, so we're going inside too.
Okay.
Over the radio to Lemons.
What?
Lemons has got his wife.
Jesus Christ, he's too drunk.
We're investigating the church where the tracks go here.
Okay.
The door is open. We're going to check it out.
I imagine he hopped up and some of the wine spilled out and he's like,
Like he was in mid drink and then he gets some message and he just puts the bottle down like, what?
Alright, so you guys.
Are still supposed to be at Reese's?
You guys, I'm working on it.
Well, for a second, I thought that was like, I didn't think that was an actual sound effect. Oh boy.
You guys enter the church.
It's Cowman.
It's pretty big. Pretty abandoned.
There's a lot of Jesus here.
And as soon as you do, I'm going to need a resolve composure.
I will resolve
Those with tolerance for biology, plus one.
I will be using
Too bad Lemon's not in here.
I don't want to throw up. Good thing I used the willpower.
I do not vomit everywhere.
Isn't it like stamina resolve or stamina composure? I don't know. It's the same role for me either way.
Same.
You're so buff, Henderson.
Flexes smell away.
You cannot taint my nostrils, you dirty plebeian.
Here. No one missed?
Did Henderson roll? Henderson rolled to get a one.
Henderson, Theo, pretty much all of you. You come in here, and it just hits you like a wall. You can only compare this smell to when you first went into Jaredaya's home.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, no.
Very sickening. Almost tart smell. Like you left something in the fridge for way too long.
Ugh.
Oh god.
Rot.
Theo, do you have your phone?
Yeah.
Henderson says, plugging his nose. We should find what's causing this smell.
Sal and Tomo, you guys notice a lot of buzzards. They're pretty much just chilling all over everything. This has been a fly breeding ground.
This specific heavy fly area concentration.
Yeah, is there like an area where there's a lot more flies than the rest of the church?
Yeah. You notice back near the altar, there seems to be a box that has a large amount of flies around it.
To the box!
Tomo's gonna go over there really carefully.
Don't worry, you got Sal back up, side up.
Oh, are you coming with?
Yeah, Sal's
back up, side up.
Yeah. He's not gonna let you walk over to this scary chest filled with next to flies by yourself.
Alright.
Oh, jeez.
So, you guys look into the chest.
Oh, God.
And I'm gonna need another resolve composure, friends.
Ugh.
Everyone?
All right.
Whoever looks in the chest.
Sal's gonna have a blip moment. Okay, we're good.
Nice.
You have a lot of resolve composure, jeez.
Theo's gonna hang back, so.
Curiosity!
Oh, yeah. God damn it, for that curiosity.
Oh, no!
You son of a bitch.
Am I roll.
Resolve composure?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Oh,
Oh, it's so tempting. What could be in the box? What's in the box?
Alright.
He inches slowly, slowly closer, but he's not. He'll let everyone else crowd around first.
You guys, look into the box. And you really should have seen this coming at this point.
Yeah, probably.
What you see in the box is there's that missing librarian. She's been gone for how many months?
Oh, no.
Oh.
Well, she was gone for a couple weeks. A
couple weeks, months.
We've only been here like a month and a half.
You've been here a couple months. Anywho, she's been gone for a while, and this horrible smell that hit you, well, you thought it was familiar. The flies definitely led you to it. And inside the box lies a body. But what's not okay with the body is that it's not like it's been chewed on or stabbed. No, 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 no. Its meat has been sliced so perfectly and neatly.
Looks at Lemons.
It looks
the one time he decides to sit out.
Oh no, he would have been so tempted.
It looks like a fine cut pig.
What?
Now, where these pieces went, you're not sure, but... And you can definitely see the rot sitting in. You got the lovely pus clinging around the edges, and the maggots have found it as well. And they're having a nice little dance party.
At least they're happy.
Her gray hair is in tangles around her neck, much like a noose. Her eyes are gone, mouth is open, and what seems to be a permanent scream.
Her hair hung her? Or was Domo's, that like symbolism?
Domo's gonna look at this and just be and just mutter to himself, "What the fuck?"
But
that's the noise Sal makes. He does a little baby vomit. But then
he does the baby vomit.
Sal will turn around and be, no. Sal will turn around and go.
We should go before anyone comes here.
How does nobody find a dead body in here, stupid town?
Is that in character?
No. Yes, it is now, actually.
Oh, no.
Well, we didn't find it either. And we are actively looking for this stuff, so.
I mean, when a church is abandoned, it's not like anyone's wanting to willingly go in here.
Who is it?
Henderson's gonna look around and see if the place has been disturbed other than the open doors.
I don't know.
Does Tomo even know?
Roll perception.
I don't think Sal knows who it is either.
Yeah, because I don't think Tomo knows the library.
Yeah!
Hey, nice. There's your eagle, Henderson.
Get that eagle.
Henderson, you're looking around and yes, this place has certainly been disturbed, but more so, you notice looking around, it looks like there's footsteps in the dust leading from the front door here, as well as what seems to be a patch of disturbed dust near the altar.
Can you investigate the disturbed patch?
You could. Let me finish first, though.
Oh, sorry.
No, you're fine, you're fine. You also notice, looking around, the altar seems off. There is what seems to be a dark crack below it. Like it's not in place completely.
Oh no.
Secret door! Is the chest like in the way of it or like...
It's in front of it.
Big arms.
Henderson's gonna like sort of pull his hands into his sleeves so he's not leaving fingerprints and try to push it aside.
All right, roll strength athletics.
Can we?
Oh yeah, I'm good at 2.
Actually, you'll be fine.
Okay.
Can we help? Can we help the Henderson?
Strong
people?
Back count for this?
I would say strong back would count for this.
Hey.
Can we help the Duval? Yes.
Oh, I keep forgetting you. I don't know if he rolls through 10. You can if you want.
Okay, strength athletics.
And it'll add to his roll.
Yeah.
Let us go. Strength athletics.
3 more dice for the double. Oh. Bam.
One more
dice for the double.
Nope. You are a great help, guys.
Hey, you know what? Henderson didn't use our help wisely.
Henderson, you're pushing on the box and what are you doing? So you, with your amazing perception check, you knew it was rotted, but as you push, it kind of gives out on you.
Oh, oh no.
And you find yourself tumbling forward as it flips, and you the body rolls out, and both of you are next to the altar.
Can we help the Henderson out?
I thought the altar was what I was pushing.
Oh, I thought you said you were pushing the box.
Oh, well, I was trying to reveal the like hidden door beneath the altar.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Please don't dump a corpse on the floor.
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
Well, that's different. I could listen. Henderson, you push, but it just... you feel like you're making some sort of traction, but it's not budging.
You're a perfectly good axe, Tomo.
I'm not
gonna chop down an altar. I think there's something underneath here, which you will repeat to Lemons. He'll take the moment to tell Lemons what they found.
I perception the altars to see if there's like a catch or a switch or...
You may.
Can I try and move it while he's looking for one?
Blips. I got a single success.
You're looking and there seems to be... what seems to be groves at the bottom of it. Like, not exactly designs, but little indents along the floor surrounding it.
It's a puzzle.
Oh. Well, maybe if you push it in a certain direction.
Alright, like, I guess we attempt pushing it in different directions.
Well, if it has the grooves in the floor, then maybe it slides along sort of like a track.
Oh. Okay, I guess you say this out loud, right?
Yeah.
Okay, Sal will be like, oh, okay, I'll try pushing it that way then. And then he'll push it the way that, or I'll try pushing it the way that Theo pointed out.
Okay.
Strength athletics again, or?
Strength athletics, my bro. If anyone wants to aid you, tell him now so he can roll the dice.
I'll forever hold your peace.
Do it.
I'll aid. Get three more dice.
Five more dice in total, so.
Oh,
you can have four more dice.
Helpful, baby.
You get
strong baby.
All right, look at all these dice you get.
In total, you got five.
Five, yeah.
Sorry, Lemon. Gotta sit this one out.
No.
Want to eat the maggots? Lots of those.
You know, he probably would.
Alright, Sal, you get a good grip on it. And you start pushing it. And you feel it give and you feel it start to move forward. And it reveals a large hole in the floor. And you know, give me a moment. This stupid hole is kind of familiar in a sense.
Oh, god damn it.
It's the graveyard.
It's an underground passageway.
Yep.
Theo
is gonna radio to Arthur.
Get Earth bonds. Yes.
Oh god, you lisped beforehand.
Fantastic. Oh my god.
Pre-lisped. That moment when you get so into character.
Did I? You
yeah,
did.
You
lisped.
You get a response.
You became Arthur before.
You'll hear it in the recording. It's beautiful.
Anyway, We found another tunnel.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, it's the old church near the dentist's office.
Well, what are you... Can you see into it? Have you tried the flashlight thing yet?
Not yet, but this one we know we can cover up. There's,
okay.
Like, the altar slides back, and it'll cover up the hole down into the cavern.
Got it.
That would imply a purposeful construction. I mean, this altar had to be built that way. This has got to be old.
Yeah, that church dates back to long before us. That's for fucking sure. Well, all right. So you flash your flashlight into it.
Yeah.
Roll a perception.
Perception.
Vibe avec tes yeux.
Same. I don't know what to mean.
See with your eyes.
Oh. Okay.
You look down, Talon. It's very, very. It's very dark, duh, but you think you see something, like a, it's not a corridor, but it's something, looks man-made in a sense, too shapely to be of a cave.
Okay, so, this cave, right, is it like, it goes diagonally down, or is it like down, then... It goes vertically down and then horizontal, or
it's,
what?
It's like a drop down from what you can tell that leads to horizontal.
Horizontal.
And not is a far like... drop down, like a jump down.
Okay. Is there like a ladder? Or is it just a drop, nothing
it's
else?
It's just a drop down.
I want to go in. Everyone's going to yell at him, though. So I want. Sal would say, I need, you know what, I'm fucking, okay, he says, I'm gonna try and get a better look, and then he jumps in.
Oh my god.
I was just like, what the fuck, Sal?
And then he flashes his flashlight down the corridor.
Alright, Sal, you do the good man thing, and you jump down.
I wanna see what's
which is there. Like, thank you, finally, someone jumped in the dungeon.
I just didn't want it to go to waste because I knew we were gonna do the smart thing and not go in.
So you did the Sal thing.
Sal has to go
exactly. Yeah,
remember, really casual reminder, Kareem. Brianna always has contingency plans.
That's a good point. Probably would have fell through anyway, or we probably would have fell through the ground or something.
Nonsense! I don't know what you're talking about.
There's probably one in the house.
Oh yeah, that's it.
Oh god. We haven't looked in our basement recently, have we?
At the end of this, I want to see all your contingency plans.
What, like, at the end of rural altogether,
yeah.
Or?
Yeah, I want to see what all your plans were, like, all what would happen.
Deal.
What happened?
Yeah, that's I like that idea.
Okay. Sal, you jump down without the permission of anyone, because Sal do is Sal do. And you come down to a long staircase.
Ooh.
Whoa.
So that would be sick. There's a staircase here.
Tomo just kind of looks at everybody and is like, should we go in or should we get him out of there? Or...
Sal, don't go any further.
Sal really wants to go for it.
Grumble guts.
Hey, Theo, roll a curiosity.
Son of a bitch.
Failed this. No!
Theo, you fight it off. You're just like, ooh, those stairs might be pretty. No!
Sal's okay. A staircase, and Theo's like, what the? A staircase underground?
I'll go down and look around and keep an eye on him. Why don't you ask Arthur? I think maybe at this point we should check it out for tomorrow or something.
Lemon's radio's in. Hey guys, what's going on? Haven't heard from you for a bit.
Everyone's dead!
Tomo replies to Lemon's. Yeah, we found another tunnel in here. Same one as in the cemetery. Sal just jumped in.
What?
Yeah.
I don't know why.
And apparently so did Henderson.
What?
He hasn't jumped in yet. He hasn't jumped in yet.
Not yet.
I was gonna say that would be a more
what?
Yeah, what?
I thought he did jump in.
Wine smells again.
Henderson said radio back to Arthur and we might sit down and look at this one a little bit.
When he hears the Henderson when he looks at his alcohol.
What? Spits out alcohol.
Shit. Sorry, I just spit taking your RV, I'll clean it up.
In character.
God.
No, it didn't happen. The long wave radio to talk to Arthur, is that in the RV or do you guys have it?
He doesn't have the long wave radio, he has his own.
Oh, he has his own, okay.
Jason has the long wave radio.
Oh, so Lemons has Jason been doing all this.
Yeah, because it's Nat and radio. So Lemons got that talk.
Okay, so he did. Never mind.
Lemons radio's Jason. Nat and Arthur. What you doing?
Yeah. Hey.
Hey.
Aren't we supposed to be updating him too?
Oh.
Well. No, he's just supposed to be there in case like something happens and we need to like call the base.
Call the base. He wouldn't mind an update now and again.
You guys never update me anymore.
You guys don't
me Wait, so oh yeah, the long range radio. And I was like, Sal would probably do that, but I don't have the long range radio.
Well, I think the long range is in the van, so Lemons has it. But
Sal will radio.
We're gonna radio Arthur.
Sal will radio Lemons to keep him updated too.
That's sweet. Oh, okay.
Stop it.
I didn't even say anything gay about it.
It's fine. I know what you were thinking.
Anyway.
I'll be the one to cross the line.
Guys,
remember the cookie cell.
Is that it?
You guys message Arthur again vocally.
Hello.
Watch out. Oh, God. What'd you see? Sal jumped in. What? He says that there's a staircase leading further down. Like, it's definitely purposeful.
Well, then it's definitely not mine, per se, if it's a staircase.
Does the church, go back to before the monster problem?
I believe so, oh yes.
It's cultists.
Monsters clearly. Jesus. Monsters invented Jesus.
I'm currently looking into this fucking hole in the ground. And from what I can tell, it goes down further, but there's no man-made structures I can see from here. They might be two completely different things.
The construction seemed similar, and
well, I don't fucking remember a staircase in the grave, Henderson.
Poor Henderson.
Oh no, he just shuts up.
Oh no.
Sorry, I just...
You hear a whimper.
Arthur has been defeated by just sadness.
I mean, it's possible the grave collapsed in on the pre-made tunnel. It's not an intended exit.
Well, you gotta get Sal back. You can't just let him run down some stairs. He's gonna trip and break his neck.
Sal is already gone. He's
running with scissors down the stairs with a match lit.
Yodeling his whole way down.
Yeah. Sal?
Oh, like that's gonna work.
we're not investigating now. We still have to, secure the rest of the town.
Sounds like.
Sal, roll a perception as you peer over the staircase.
Oh yes, Sal wants to peer over the staircase. So it's an adventure. Adventure!
Oh my god.
Sal, you look down And in normal cases, it'd be really hard to see through all that darkness. But there seems to be a glow down there. Oh, Christ.
Oh, jeez.
Candlelight? No. Is that a room?
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
So... Bree's cheating. She's there's something glowing down here. I'm just gonna
Sal.
Give me a
sec. Sal.
His voice is getting farther away. At least he didn't step on his walkie-talkie this time.
Yeah.
Should I be coming in or should I stay in the RV?
We might need you.
Why don't we all stay together? We don't want to get separated and a murderer to come back upstairs or something.
Oh, okay. I'm coming
in. Why did
in.
You say murderer? On Henderson.
Well, I mean, the body is clean, like, is butchered, which, mm-hmm. Mostly humans do butchering.
Is the long wave radio, portable, or is it stuck in the RV?
No. It's stuck. Think Leopard
okay.
Dead.
Okay.
Let Jason know what's happening.
Oh, is that what Henderson said before? Lemons left.
Yeah.
Lemons will beep boop Jason.
Yes.
Henderson calls down, "We're coming after you, Sal. Please stop. We'll be there in a second."
Just stop, Sal.
Stop, just stop.
Sal will sit down on one of the steps. Okay.
I like to imagine he walked like 2 or 3 steps downward just to be petulant and then sat down.
I just like to imagine Sal's like snacks on him. Just sitting there eating in this disgusting fucking hole. Oh my God.
It's the way Sal lives his life.
You mean he doesn't have like a Cheeto pocket in his defense
not
against
his Mountain Dew? It's Mountain Dew and Cheetos.
Hey, he is not a gremlin, thank you.
He's not a gamer grill. My brother hates those memes so much.
Excuse me, they're not Cheetos. They're actually supposed to be Doritos.
he thinks they're like stereotypical of gamers, and he like finds them offensive.
That's the whole point of them, and they're funny.
I know.
They're funny, and they're great because they're not sexualizing her. They are making her this evil little gremlin. That's amazing.
How did this even happen? Lemons, you updoot the Jason. Jason is like, cool.
Okay.
Hey, you guys get a message from Arthur.
So what's the plan of action? What are you doing?
I will attempt to map where this goes. We're just gonna take a look down and then come back up.
Alright, but if there's any sign of... Ah, shoot, I'm having a actual GM brain fart.
Danger?
Danger?
Not danger.
Hey, Henderson.
Monsters?
Henderson.
Activity?
Spooky.
Henderson.
Any sign of spook?
No. It's those things.
Anthropophages?
No.
Oh.
No. Also, props, Nick, for remembering that.
Thanks.
Wait, what did he remember?
The whole name of the creature.
Well, you've told me the name like three different
got
times.
Got it. If there's any sign of mind, you come up. Understood?
Oh, the mind.
Yeah.
Good. Probably keep on radioing every now and then to make sure you don't lose connection.
Okay.
If our signal can come up from
got
underground.
It. Well, let's fucking hope, shall we?
Wait. Was that an actual really happy Arthur Good? Because that was really happy.
That
Sunday.
Wasn't happy. That was agitated.
it was sarcasm, excited. Son.
That was Tomo failing his empathy on Arthur.
That was the most excited good I've heard out of Arthur. I'm sorry.
It was falsely cheerful.
Uh-huh. So, Lemons wants to know if Henderson wants the RV locked up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Park it somewhere not suspicious.
It's an RV. Where is not suspicious?
I mean, not, like, pulled into the abandoned parking lot on the side of the road, or, you know.
Not directly next to the church.
Well, yeah, Lund is going to use his best judgment for parking the RV. Which, I don't know what best judgment would be at this point, so should I roll?
Yes. Roll a...
I mean, you could park it back at the house and just walk over.
It is pretty close.
What's the point of having the RV, then?
Would you like to do a stealth drive?
Do it.
That's a crit failure. I am not doing that. He will drive it to an empty parking lot. Not parking lot, but I'm sure there's... can you tell if there's any houses here that aren't lived in?
Roll a perception.
Oh, no.
Where'd they come from? Where'd they go? Where'd they come from? Cotton Eye Joe.
So, his idea of stealth maneuvering an RV is parking it across the street.
Nailed
from the church.
It's better than nothing.
Very stealthy. And Lemons thinks it's super stealthy too. He's like, yeah.
He leaves like a branch.
You did
on
good,
it.
Lemons.
There's camouflage.
You did. It's a really shitty, like, small twig.
All right, you've stealthed and parked it. And just perfect.
We gotta put the RV back. Snake legs.
You put a cardboard box on it.
Oh yeah, there we go.
It's a cardboard box.
And so. You meet up with the group. Lemons, you come in here. Roll resolve composure, because, yeah, smell.
No.
With all your bonuses.
Oh, shoot. That's...
What? Plus three?
I don't know what that
Lemons
is.
Lemons laughs at your roll.
It's plus
Lemons
something.
Don't that smells tasty.
We'll pretend it's
yeah, it's
two.
Your roll not to eat it.
It smells like
yeah,
a good time.
Yo.
You're fine. You're like, oh, it smells like
he
home.
He doesn't even have to cover his body. He actually takes a big whiff in.
Yeah, he comes in and he doesn't even like make a face at the smell.
Smells like home.
Everyone else is like covering their noses and mouths, and that was like, hi.
Yeah, someone
smells
please
like
notice
something died.
Well, he's a medical examiner. He's used to it.
Mm-hmm.
No, true.
Except for that one time with the kid.
Yeah, well, he was up close and personal.
Is Matt assumed to be following along in this, by the way?
No, she's with Arthur.
Oh, okay.
Henderson says there's a dead body in the chest, don't look.
Oh.
Or do look, you're a medical examiner.
Just kind of.
Oh no, you just signed yourself up for Lemons getting a little snack.
I'm gonna be like, I'll catch up, it'll come last.
Can you tell us how she died?
Goes over and takes a peeksy.
You may roll your wits medical.
Mm. Wits medical 4. 3.
You're looking and the problem with bodies that have been this badly mauled is that it's always hard to tell what starts and what ends.
Right.
It's just one big pile of ugh. But...
I can say it wasn't pretty.
But you turn her over and you do notice most of the meat on her back area is just gone. So maybe it started from there? Maybe she got clawed, but it's also so neat as well. Oh.
Oh, jeez.
Poor dear.
Lemons is admiring the the craftsmanship.
Hmm.
He's like such fine butchery.
I'm surprised he's not like, oh, gross. Ah, like he just, how terrible.
So yeah, you look at it, and you can't get an exact reading on how she died.
Mm-hmm.
But you know that, oh, she died bad.
And she's stanky.
And it looks like, from the timing of all this, you know, using the flies and all that, you feel like she died before getting cut up.
Mm. Oh, that's Monsalus, right?
Well, you can kind of... I was going to go off on a... I used to watch crime shows a lot. Lol.
Oh, the blood stops. Something. The heart stops.
Clot, you wouldn't something. See any, around the wounds. You wouldn't see any, like, residual bleeding because she doesn't have a response to the tissue doesn't have the response anymore. Like, wounds made before she died would have, like, trauma and stuff around them. Wounds made after wouldn't have the same response.
I always thought that was
unless, I thought it was, if it was, like, immediately after they died, there would still be some, or no? I don't know.
I think a little bit. But...
Yeah.
Well, let's go down in the hole.
Yeah.
Going down the hole.
Henderson's like, I'm tired of this chit-chat.
We gotta go get Sal.
You guys enter the hole.
Wait, who's entering the hole?
Whoever wants to enter the hole.
Lemons is busy doing other things.
Oh my god. Lemon.
Oh, Henderson's gonna go down. It's like, we're coming, Sal.
Alright, Henderson, you get
Do we
down.
Have a clear way back up?
Stairs.
The stairs do not lead all the way up.
I thought there was like a little jump down.
There's a little jump down and then there's stairs.
Okay, can we get one of those, like, benches and, like, lean it through the hole so it's like a little slide?
Drag a pew over here?
Yeah.
You may strength just athletics
drag the
plus strong back.
Sacrilege.
I'd say that's enough to take the thingy, the pew, when you lean it down. It's a little short, but it does the job.
Just lemons in the distance.
I don't think he'd be saying that. I think he'd be like, because he's got a snack.
Snick.
Henderson will radio in and say, we'll check in every 5 minutes.
Sounds good.
Okie dokie, here we go.
Here we go.
That was in character.
Jesus,
yeah,
no.
Imagine, okie dokie. I just imagine Henderson doing that and I was just like, oh my god.
Yes, god. Losing it.
It's finally getting.
He's going down the rabbit hole.
Literally.
So who?
Henderson's down.
Who all is entering the hole, please?
Sal isn't. No, I'm just gonna.
Lemons will probably linger.
Tomo is in the hole.
He always does.
All right, Tomo's in the hole.
Well, Henderson's whole deal was that they shouldn't split up, so
should all go together.
Henderson's whole deal.
Yeah.
Thanks, Kareem.
He'll be coming down, just not first because
Theo,
those first things could happen.
Are you joining them as well then?
Yeah, he'll go down because the idea was to stick together.
Yeah. Lemons, you're the last one.
Are you gonna notice the lemon not going in the hole until?
No, he will be.
No,
Theo can
like...
roll a perception if he'd like.
No, he's
Theo,
coming.
Theo,
Jesus.
Notice it. Notice. Oh my god. You're being awfully slow, Lemons.
He's coming in the hole.
Lemons, what are you doing up there?
He's just lingering because it could be dangerous.
That's not why. Theo
helps
Don't
him.
Lie.
Theo, you notice that Lemons seems to be hesitating. You notice so well. You feel like you see his attention is diverted elsewhere. I'd even allow for an empathy.
Whoa. No.
Oh, <God. laughs> As Theo like strikes Lemons, he feels it.
Like the mere mention of empathy triggers Andrea. I love it.
No, you get minuses on that shit.
Get away from me!
Minus
get away!
Because I said so.
Not touchy.
You get minus two.
Don't
die. Shit.
I just imagine when people try to connect with Lemons, he gets sharp teeth and he's like, no, get away!
Why does he get minus two?
Because I have rigid mask.
Oh, okay.
It's minus two.
But those were lying so specifically.
It's real emotions.
Okay.
Oh, well, yeah, I guess anyone attempting to see through his lies or figure out what your character's real emotions are.
No, I would allow it.
Cool.
Okay, so minus two?
Yes.
I will roll 5 instead of 7.
Fuck.
Should have rolled a will.
You're dealing with Theo.
Theo, you're looking at Lemons and he's looking longingly at something. Is it you? No. It's...
He's
get out of here. Get that thought out of here.
Is it me you're looking for?
Could it be? Is he secretly really religious and just so hurt that they're moving the pews? Something's off. It's not just hesitation.
Theo will wait before he goes down. He'll walk over. You okay, guy?
The whole situation. I don't like it.
Yeah, I'm... The whole situation.
Oh, God.
Shut up, yes. Sal.
Oh, God, don't turn this into a...
He said to stay together, I guess. Lemons will allow himself to be cajoled down.
Alright, you get cajoled down and you enter the
You're meatless
hole.
Now.
You're meatless.
Meatless Mondays.
I want the meat.
You guys!
Trapped between your two loves.
Yep. Pretty much. Literally.
You guys walk down the stairwell for a while. Nice, lots of echoes. You know, it sounds very big. It goes down for, God, you can't even tell how long. But eventually, you come to what seems to be...
No, son of a bitch, Inky. Sorry, Bree.
You're fine.
God damn it, Ink.
Eventually, you guys come to what seems to be a large opening.
Ooh, oh. That's not terrifying at all.
Oh.
So you just happened to find a picture that was super fitting for your situation.
I was using my Photoshop skills.
Oh, nice. Oh, it's nice.
I didn't make all of it. I cropped out the character that was in it.
Oh, well, it's still nice.
God bless Bloodborne, am I right?
Still oh, this is, I should have known this is Bloodborne. Are those giant things that are invisible?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What? What are you trying to say, Bree?
You enter.
That's interesting.
You
radioing back.
It's underground. Does it reach still? Whoops. Spelled it wrong.
Can we radio back? Does it reach?
One moment.
Right. Oh, there's broken radio noises.
Oh, no. I don't like it.
You don't like the fact that we can't have contact with the outer world anymore?
It seems
Here
that you cannot.
She married a man of sin.
Oh, hi, GLaDOS.
GLaDOS is in the hall.
Potatoes lament.
Looks up.
Wait,
where is she? She married a man
We're
of sin.
We're all a bunch of idiots. He fell right into my trap.
Oh, hello.
We should probably call in before.
Do you want to run up the stairs and let him know?
Is there more downstairs here?
I believe that is more downstairs.
Alright, Sal will peek over the more downstairs.
No, there is no more. It's just this grand expanse of a room.
Can you perceive everything here?
Yes, please roll a perception.
Okay, and then I want to occult after that.
Is everyone rolling perception?
Yes.
Oh, I got lucky there.
Oh, it's not terrible.
You have really unlucky rolls, Nick.
I do. I really do. I'm telling you.
I really do.
Theo, you don't know what to make of all of this. You really don't.
It's weird. It's uncomfortable.
These sculptures, this writing, it just doesn't make any sense. Why are the candles on?
Who came down here and lit all these candles?
Lemons and Tomo. Mm-hmm. You notice the writing on the wall. Literally, it's the writing on the wall. And...
that Henderson read aloud.
I hope that wasn't...
and it seems to be carved in. Oh, GLaDOS, please. We're gonna find a different version of GLaDOS. Song, yeah.
Can I do an investigation to see, like, what carved into the wall?
You may
have to go... hold, what? Wait, Tomo.
Wait.
He's just going over to the writing. It's no big deal.
Well, Theo is like, we should call and say what we found before we go in.
Henderson gave Theo, like, said maybe you should run upstairs where the radio reaches.
Gonna, gonna roll Wits Investigation.
I was leaving an opening for Lemons to offer.
Yeah.
If you wanted to be.
Lemons will definitely offer. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah. He'll I'll be back. Okay.
And see, then I could immediately counter it and say, "Oh, but so, we should send two people." To-
is Tomo waiting?
Are you gonna do it? You should totally
to
do it.
To investigate, or is he going in?
He's gonna wait until he hears something back from Theo.
Okay.
Can Henderson roll occult along with Sal? Or I guess we need to see what our three perceptions.
Your threes. You guys get everything, all the above. But you note, now, you guys aren't architects or anything, but even though you went down a lot of stairs, this building, this room, it seems disproportionately large for how long you went down. It doesn't
fit. So like we should see the stairs?
Like, no, as in the room. With how tall these ceilings are, you feel like it should there should be a hole in the church above.
We're a different dimension. We're in the hedge.
Super duper.
We're in the smidge. I don't know anything about the hedge, so that doesn't make sense. Do you have more occult than me? Yeah.
Theo will go up with Lemons.
Is it what's occult?
Love it.
Oh, I have five too.
Stick
so
together,
matter.
Make sure nobody gets separated.
I guess I'll roll and then you will help.
Okay.
Alright, well.
We're up in pieces.
Lots of pieces. Alright, well, that sucks. Sorry.
Look at all the threes, though. That's almost a perfect set of threes.
Yep, I should get a point for that. I guess you could do that. Never mind, forget I then we're yeah, you have your own roll.
What are we rolling?
It's their rolling fault.
Yeah.
Oh. The other, you two are able to go up the stairs, that's fine.
Yep, and then we radio and the really, really fucked up room we found.
You guys go up. May I get a perception as you head up?
One.
Damn. As for Henderson, what did you get for your cult? Two successes?
Two, yes.
Okay.
You know this creepy shit?
This creepy shit is definitely creepy. What you get out of it is... it's definitely cult-like. Something made long ago by just the way it's made. You know, it's hand-sculpted, handmade. However, with these sculptures on the side here, your cult role is able to easily recognize it as not only a more witch-like symbol, but definitely demonic.
Dagmar?
Okay. Dadmar?
Dad?
No.
There's nothing dadly about that demon.
And this is something I personally know, that like witches are often accused of like marrying or being in concert with demons or the devil. Can
yes,
you know
that is something you can get out of this.
Okay, so Henderson will say that, and it might have something to do with here he married a man of sin, or she married a man of sin.
He. gay witches, gay witches.
And just start chanting.
Room starts on fire. That's what was needed.
You just have to chant gay witches 3 times.
And the gay witches will appear in front of you.
And repeat, gay Mary, gay Mary, gay Mary. Is it a Bloody Mary?
Perfect.
Alright.
Alright, and for you, those of you who are going upstairs, you head upstairs.
Yep.
I have no problems with that.
Oh, okay.
Roll a perception as you
it's around. The altar, isn't it?
Another perception? We both rolled...
Oh, you already rolled?
Yeah, one.
We both rolled 1 success.
Okay, yeah.
And now Lemon's also rolled another 1.
Yes, because I'm amazing.
I hear gentle breeze outside. Sounds like rain as well.
Oh boy.
It's time for death.
Lemon will radio broadcast that we found this creepy ass room.
You put up your lovely, lovely radio. How new is this? Probably like, what, 2012 at least? You know, it's seen better days, you feel like. Definitely seen better days.
Train! I like to imagine he turned on the radio and a train just came by.
Wait, so I couldn't get through with the radio?
Static.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Well, we told him something's we'd check here in every 5 minutes, so he'll know who means up.
Hmm.
Well, usually static means something's here.
Oh. Well, Henderson's not there to... Yeah. Oh,
well, that was Theo piping up.
Maybe we should join the others.
Can we take a look around before we head back? See if there's any noticeable signs of something being disturbed other than what we've moved?
You may.
Oh boy. 2.
You may roll as well, Lemons.
Ooh, that's a good level.
Oh, see with your lemony eyes.
We should go back down.
Theo, you're looking around and you can't seem to see anything. Lemons, did you guys just not notice the hoof prints in the dust before?
Mm.
Or were they not there?
Mm. No!
Nope.
Hello? Lemons is going to urge Theo to come downstairs. We need to go down.
Yeah, we have to let him know that something's up with the radio.
Mm-hmm. When we go down.
Heading back.
You guys head back down. And Tomo, you wanted to investigate?
Yeah, I wanted to see what made that little scratchy thing on the wall.
Alright, you head over there, Tomo.
If you can tell what kind of tool made it.
If a tool made it at all.
You go over there, and you're getting close to check it out. You know, run a thumb along the carvings to see if you can recognize it. I mean, hey, you've held an ice pick and such in your life every now and then. This can't be that much different, right? And so, you do. And as you do, blood starts to ooze from these carvings.
Uh-oh, what'd you do?
He's immediately gonna back up when he notices that.
Taste the blood.
Tomo, I'm gonna need you to actually roll your defense for me, please.
Oh shit.
Defend against the blood.
Not a door.
This no, it's just one area.
Okay.
Defend against the blood.
Am I just
blood
straight hurts. Up rolling 2d10 then?
Yes.
It's a good thing I have.
Get this. Get these drawings out of here. I was drawing in the blood.
I thought that was Brianna.
Yes, I couldn't tell. I actually thought it was either Brianna or Andrea. I didn't think it would be.
Tomo. Yeah. You pull away just in time as what what seems to be a bloody hand bursts from the wall.
Oh no.
What the fuck?
Only to go back into the wall, leaving something new.
Oh.
Yeah, Tomo's gonna straight up scream, what the fuck, like, as that happens.
Wait, how do you leave words?
Of equal sin?
Of equal sin?
It means that she was done fucked too.
Maybe we should get out of here.
Tomo immediately nods his head and is like, yeah, we need to leave.
You wanna keep it?
Does anyone else have a camera phone on them? Besides Theo, who went upstairs, and Lemons, who went upstairs?
Didn't they come, back down?
They were making their way back
They're on their way back down while Tomo was touching things.
Thanks, Tomo.
So do we come back in to see everyone freaking out?
Yes. I'm actually going to need everyone to roll a perception, please. Oui.
Roll your special eyes.
Oh my god.
Almost too
you
freaked
are
out.
So unlucky, god damn.
I should seriously get something for the 3 7s, though.
No.
Denied.
I'm kidding.
I do redemption because you're in denial.
You just shut your mouth and.
I like how there is a little Kareem in the background there.
All right, you guys feel a low rumble as the earth around you shakes.
Let's go up now.
And there is a sound of howling wind.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
Time to run. Go, go, go.
Yep, Tomo is outing. He's straight outing.
We didn't even make it all the way down, did we? We just started coming down in the rumble.
You guys made it down to the opening.
Okay. And then everyone's turning around.
Yes.
Okay, back up.
Sal will let everyone run in front of him first, because he doesn't want to leave anyone behind.
He just doesn't want to leave.
Yeah, you got him!
He wants to see the demon when it comes.
You guys...
He can murder it with his own two hands.
Run upstairs.
Yo, Theo will try and relay on the way that the radio is out. Something's happening upstairs.
Oh, that's good. So it's gonna be either Wendigo or Bloody Cave. Or you guys wanna choose.
Or just run for your lives, that's always a good one.
Silly lemon.
Well, I mean, we are trapped with both, basically, if we stay down the stairs. I mean,
well, the only exit is up.
Downstairs. Yes,
so
we're going
we'll
up,
have to
up.
Get by whatever is there.
I mean, what if the things down here follow us up there?
You are going to push the altar back over it.
Oh, I wasn't actually saying that. So I would never...
That smart.
Yeah, he's not. That he realizes that leaving is the best option. I was just wondering. That was just me wondering. Yeah, so I guess we're all running up, crying, and peeing ourselves.
Alright, you guys run up, crying, and peeing yourselves.
Cannon.
Maybe oh Sal. God.
Roll to wet pants.
Roll the piss pants.
Roll a perception as you enter back.
Everyone
I blame lemons
or
for
just
people.
Everyone.
If I roll a really bad roll, I need to roll a
oh
bunch of
god.
Die. Oh my god. Finally.
you finally beat everyone else who all had twos.
You didn't beat me.
Well, I'm on par with you. That's okay.
That's better than nothing.
Exactly. It's better than a fucking zero success roll.
Finally, after all these years.
I can finally see again.
Oh my god.
I can clearly know that the fail is gone.
Oh my god, man.
10 out of 10. Beautiful.
I can see all the monsters in my way.
Blah, 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 blah.
Alright. You all notice as you come up, the box is gone.
Something ate it.
Yeah.
Just gone, like it was never there, like it was whisked away.
Lemons. Dang.
Well, don't matter. We need to leave anyways.
Mm-hmm. Gotta go right now.
Yeah, so we all continue to run.
Alright. Just booking it.
You guys...
Well, Henderson's gonna push that altar back over the hole.
Alright, roll a strength, athletics, Henderson, plus strong back.
I'm going to use a willpower.
Here, you can... All right, you want some help from a small?
Gonna be fine.
Well, I'm pretty good with the willpower.
Yeah, I was gonna help, but then she said willpower, so I think she's fine. I need a little help there.
13 d10? Oh, willpower, okay. Forgot.
Oh, sorry, it should have been 12, not 13.
It's fine. You push it over. You're like, no, I ain't dealing with this, bye.
Do you have 8 strength? Or, not 8, 4 strength and 4 athletics?
Yes. I said it should have been 12, I accidentally did 13. Ah. Three strength, 4 athletics, 2 from strong back, another 3 from willpower.
Strong dead.
You push it over and you feel like, as you are leaving, you are definitely not alone.
Nice.
Oh my god. Wait, do we actually hear this in the room?
You hear it all around you as you're leaving.
Oh sure.
Boy.
Well, shit.
No.
We have a cop villain now.
You guys
just straight up runs.
Yeah.
And then you guys exit outside.
Oh, okay. That the doors are gonna slam on us.
Oh god.
Where the building's gonna go to another dimension. I'm calling it.
You exit outside.
Hooray.
And look how nice it is outside.
What?
Wait a minute.
Wait.
So nice. Are we in the woods?
You went out the back door.
Okay.
Oh. Okay.
Oh.
Teleporting off stage.
Yep.
No.
Do not want. Immediately checks radio. You don't have static.
That's good.
Person's gonna be closing the back door and the front door and looking for a good branch or something to sit with.
I'm sorry, what?
Person's gonna be closing the back doors and front doors and be looking for like nice big sturdy branches to brace it with. In fact, he will even ask Tomo to, like, chop a log for him.
Oh, yeah, he'll do that. Yeah, he'll do that.
Go ask some woods.
He needs to ask me some questions.
Yep. Well, Arthur is getting a very garbled call right now. We found a thing. It's really fucked up.
What? What did you find?
There's a room at the end of the stairs, and it was full of all these weird statues and bullshit, and there was, like, writing carved onto the wall, and it looked super weird and creepy, and, when we came upstairs to try and call you the first time, the radio didn't work, so we went back downstairs, but then, like, the walls were bleeding, and then we left, and it's super weird, and, yep, we're trying to lock up the church right now.
Sounds like a plan.
Just like, God, I hate being in charge.
Arthur is not equipped to deal with this bullshit.
Just like, I don't like people.
What would the point of pushing stuff in front of the doors be if it can just go out the windows anyways?
We don't know what can go out the windows.
But I think our main concern right now is to keep any possible civilians out.
Hmm. I mean, the doors were open when we got here, which implies whatever it was going through them, so at least that's not happening. Henderson says as he constructs his elaborate...
uses algebra and geometry to make the best fucker.
If you'd like to block the doors, you may roll a... I'd say dex crafts.
Do you want to assist?
Sure.
Or he assist Theo? I will assist Theo.
Okay.
So, here is for the... Ooh, you get 3 extra dice, Theo.
Ooh.
Excellent.
7 and 9.
Good job. Already rolling 7, so let's roll 10. Alright, for fuck's sake.
Anderson could have done it himself better.
You take a nice branch and you just plop. That's gotta work. It's gonna work.
Henderson's like crafting god.
Here you go.
You can't make a proper barrier, you're not a dad yet.
Yeah, he hasn't learned how to build a deck. He needs to take dad lessons.
Soon wild dads will flock here. It's the best picture.
Find a nice child you can adopt. And you can truly become a dad.
So, we might want to check the rest of the town for other entrances.
Yeah.
But I didn't see another exit that would go to a tunnel that led to the cemetery.
Well, how this one thorough seemed... were you guys?
I mean, there wasn't any holes in the walls.
What time is it?
It's around 4:30.
Okay.
So we have storm, like, seems what? To be getting thicker.
Maybe call it for the evening. Or do you guys want to risk one more place?
I think we should double check the next most populous place and make sure.
Henderson thinking about others.
Where would the next spot be?
The stores, I guess.
Just down Main Street, take a loop.
Yeah.
I mean, that's quick enough that we can drive by, make sure everything's all set, head back to base.
We can, yeah, just keep your eyes on the ground, make sure there's no other holes.
Lemons tosses the keys to Henderson.
Henderson catches the keys!
Oh, man.
He's a basketball star, that's his secret.
Secondly, the
roll to catch keys.
He catches the keys.
Oh my god.
You got him.
I like how you bothered to do that.
And I love how you had that roll on deck, too.
You guys enter the car. Let me change you.
We have the car.
The car.
I'll never say it's the car.
You're in the car.
We are in the car.
What is happening?
We are the French. On Eiffel Tower.
Oh, we need to do this residential area.
That's a really uniform place. I would want to live there.
You would?
Yeah, look how uniform it is.
Yeah.
God, Symmetra.
Beep, 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 beep,
beep. All right, so where do you guys head?
We're heading to this residential area to do a loop.
Okay.
You okay, Kareem?
What? Yeah, I'm fine.
You have the Ridge Street and all the lanes. So which one would you like to go to first? Yeah.
You can go to this one first, since the steel mill is an area of interest. And then hit the others on our way back. So we hit, like, the upper half this way.
Yeah.
at the comb. We just have comb brushes.
We just have to be careful because the closer we get to the steel mill, the more likely we're going to get this weird time distortion.
True.
And it's already late.
Well, then better hit first if we intend to go there.
We can start here and loop back.
Okay.
Like, because if we encounter any weird time stuff, we'll at least be, you know, heading towards the exit out of the area.
Alright, sounds good.
Alright, you head to the steel mill first. And you stop by.
Henderson's keeping his eyes on the sky, using the sun as time teller.
Alright, roll a perception, Henderson.
Is that the perception?
Yes.
Not like science or survival.
Well, I mean, if you'd like to use science or survival, I'll allow that as well.
Science, intelligence, wits?
Whatever. Why is there a giant scribble on this? I don't know.
He's scribbled.
That's my perception, and I'll roll my science as well.
Okay.
Oh, no science for Henderson.
You make a perception, and as you drive, you're worried because it's getting dark, but you can't tell if it's getting dark because of the storm or because you're losing time. But it's not terribly dark, just gray, if you know what I mean.
Yeah. Okay.
The rest of you arrive at the steel mill, your car pulls up. It's just as abandoned as you remembered it, just as overgrown. You remember the days. Theo, you remember the days when the slug was here? Ah, yes.
Ah, yes.
Can I check if the pocket watch is gone?
No.
You may.
Should I perception?
Where'd you put it again?
They left it on the ground, like, in front of the ramp as they were leaving.
All right. Roll a perception.
Bam.
It is gone.
Oh.
More.
Well, maybe Omega got it back. Or Bird took it.
Or maybe some hooligan went out and stole it.
Yeah, some girl was like, shame.
We should go check the clock while we're here, though it'll probably be
crazy
screwed up since we know. Actually, I'm going to check my phone.
You check your phone.
Is it freaking out?
It's not freaking out at this very moment.
Okay. He's going to keep that handy just in case.
Alright, so everyone should do perception checks, right? That's where...
Mm-hmm.
Looking around.
Doing your lookies.
Oh!
Wow.
Oh my god.
Lemons is acutely aware because he's hungry.
He had an opportunity and it was snatched from him.
It was meat blocks.
I had to roll a bunch of dye to like refresh my pool because holy shit.
Alright. We're going to talk about your successes. And after this, Nick, if you'd like to roll 1,000 d10 to try and fix it, you may.
I don't think that's actually how it works.
It's a myth, but it's it makes you feel
better.
You told
me it works!
It's a myth.
You told me it works!
That's not how random number generation works.
It makes us feel better.
Yeah.
Just trust anyway.
Monster, you better. Told me it works.
I lied.
Here we go.
You should have kept it.
Whatever.
Tomo, not
that's a lot of successes. Is that your perception dice?
I meant like after the perception. No, I have to scroll.
Do you need us to type again?
Nah, it's fine. I found them. Okay.
So much effort coming up.
Tomo, you're walking in this area and you stop and you look at the tree.
Oh no!
And on the tree is a moth.
A moth.
My God! Takes a picture, writes it down.
It's not a slug this time.
You thought it'd be a slug, but it wasn't a slug at all.
Hmm.
It was, in fact, a nice little moth.
Is it just chilling there?
Just chilling there.
Aww.
Sitting on the clock. Henderson.
Yes.
You're looking around, and there's not much difference you can tell from the last time you were here. You see the clock, and naturally, and the rest of you notice this as well, naturally the clock is hecka messed up. Theo and Sal, you all notice this. You also notice that there seems to be a couple new spray paints on...
Who even has time to come out here and spray paint it?
Young jerks.
Jerks.
Kids who were bored.
You do notice one new sprinkler, however. It's of a clock.
Yeah.
Someone spray painted a clock?
Yes.
Huh.
And lemons.
Yes.
You notice all this, and you also notice little. I just threw my mouse.
Little feeties.
Yes, you notice little point feeties, footprints going into the woods.
What in the world? He says that too because he wasn't around the last time you guys figured out that the little feeties were omega feets.
I mean, we know he has pointy feeties.
Yeah, but he's not.
Feet is feety.
I don't know if Lemons would connect the fact that these are actually little footprints of Omega.
I don't think
so. And not
so.
Just, like, really weird indentation.
Indents, right. So he points them out.
Little peggles.
Well, Theo remembers, so he'd be like, oh.
I recognize these pegs.
We figured out last time that these are probably the tracks that Omega makes when he walks.
Oh, that would make sense, wouldn't it?
So, definitely still here. And, the watch that we found that we left out for him is gone, so might have come back and got that as well.
Oh, and Lemons kind of perks at you guys mentioning the watch. And says, I guess, by the way, since you guys were here before, did you guys ever find a photocopy of the picture?
Yeah! That was real, like, we were trying to figure out where that came from!
Lemons just smiles.
What did you do?
I left a copy. I mean, you seem to like it so much.
Oh! Man, that threw us off so much. There's a little room underneath some of the machinery that it seems like Omega's been using as like a little nest, and we found it in there.
Oh, really?
We had no idea how it got in there.
No way, I just left it near out here.
Well, I guess he took it.
Huh. Interesting. You may or may not notice he takes a slight mirth in the antics.
So we're just not gonna talk about the fact that Clockman is going towards the residential area.
Clockman, keep your feet off the ground.
Does Sal say that out loud?
Yes, actually, he will say that because Sal wants to kill it and he doesn't understand why.
It was a child!
He didn't know that.
Yes, you did.
We told you in the debriefing, Sal.
No, Sal wasn't there when you guys talked about it.
Yes, he was.
No, because I wasn't there. Because I wasn't there. Sal was like in the bathroom.
Oh, right. Oh.
So Sal doesn't know that still.
Oh, shit.
So Sal will say, Clockman. And then he'll say, you know, fucking, he's going towards the residential area.
He's coming towards us.
That's a pretty bad thing.
Clockman.
Well.
Master of the time, man.
Champion of the
gun.
What?
Why gun?
Because it fits and it
doesn't. Champion of the sun still would have worked. He's time.
Gun. Anyways, I'm sorry, I did gun. That was me.
Anyway.
Master of the clock.
Ah!
It sounded distressed.
Well, Theo will continue. It's, well, Omega's been completely non-aggressive as far as we've seen. Like, even when we were here. Last time, it didn't try to do anything, so I don't think it's as dangerous as some of the other stuff we've run into.
Fair enough.
I guess that's all there is here. We should probably get going.
Sal is not happy.
He doesn't want to. He wants to kill it.
I thought Sal was in the room for this part. I like, he'd come out of the toilet. But anyway.
No, it was after that. He came in only when they started talking about their mission.
Oh, yeah, the club mission.
Yeah.
Came in just in time for that.
Looks like a butt heart.
What?
Heart butt.
Where?
I rock. It looks like a butt heart.
Nice.
So, what do you do?
Hmm?
What do y'all do?
Can I put... I want to survive all those tracks. I want to look at... Good fucking look at those tracks.
You may survive all those tracks.
Will.
Henderson is sitting in the van, listening to the long-range radio.
Oh, okay. You're sitting this one out again?
Yeah. He's gonna keep track of the static on the short-range radio systems.
Sal, you get a pretty good idea of where they're going. I mean, they're pretty distinct footprints, so it's not hard to follow the little piggies.
Okay. Make sure there's no surprises.
Little piggies.
So, you guys sit here. Sal has determined the location of the piggies.
Probably gonna go kill someone.
Is he just wandering off?
He'll follow it a little bit. He won't go very far, but he'll follow it a tiny bit to make sure, or to see if he can more closely see if it like goes somewhere different than the residential area. It's like, well, right turn, and I'm like, all right.
It seems on a very specific path.
Ooh, specific path. All the monsters are meeting, having a monster conversation.
And wait, I'd like to respecify, not the residential area with the church.
The one right next to us?
Yes. Yeah.
So when you say specific path, are you saying it's like clearly going somewhere?
Like it doesn't seem like, you know when something dawdles, it kind of like goes this way, goes this way. It doesn't, it's like going straight.
So it's like, I know where I'm going.
Yeah, it's like, I know exactly where I'm going.
The tracks don't like turn back on themselves or sort of weave. They're in a fairly like contained path.
Okay, well Sal will relay the information that the tracks are going a very specific place. Omega knows where it's going.
Where to come from, where to go.
It has a mind.
Or also, you know, it's like, oh, hey, friend in the village. Hello, friend, I'm Clockman.
And the guy's like, of the time, the kid, man.
The kid goes, the kid goes, you're a clock. And then that's it.
You're a clock. You're crazy.
Fan fiction written by Sal.
And then Sal kills him.
A reason of why Omega is a madman. It was a child that came into the woods, it saw the clock, man, and it just disappeared, man.
Man.
We already know Omega hangs around here, so we're kind of losing light. We might want to check the houses.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so they go.
And so they went.
Wrangle Sal.
Yeah.
Sal, get in the car.
He starts growling. No.
So we're...
Lasso him.
Are we following the tracks then into the residential area to try to find out where they're going, or...
We may do it
in this area in general.
Let's do that. Sal wants to do that.
So if you'd like to roll another tracking, you may.
Oh.
Back home.
Over there I think would be a different day though.
Yeah.
Where? I bet that's where it's heading.
This is my chance.
The orphanage.
Oh, no, it's not going that way.
It's going towards like over this way.
Over here.
Oh.
Continuous like, tracking.
Into nice. These house areas.
Oop. So
look at that nice 5 tracking. What? Who rolled that? What?
I guess we could go up and down each street. And see which houses are inhabited, because we haven't actually been up here very much.
One sec, I need to... This is my tradition. I need to pee really bad, so...
Why don't you just sit on the toilet when you GM? I don't understand.
Because I'm at a non-portable computer, you doofus.
Well, plug it in.
Just unplug it.
I'm going to take the opportunity to pee as well.
All right, everyone go pee.
I'm going to take the opportunity to not pee, but...
Bio break, go.
Bio break, I like that.
Is it just me, or do I get the idea that Sal would probably just write up fake reasons why they should kill monsters?
Hey, there's no fake reason. The only reason is that they're monsters, and that's a good enough reason.
Those are going on his blog, excuse you.
Oh yeah, thanks for reminding me to do that.
Yeah, he's just gonna be like, alright, there's a clock monster in town, right? And it totally abducted this kid, and the kid was like, whoa man, you can't just do that. You can't just be a clock man. And it just disappeared. Both of them.
Magic.
That's how the post ends. Just a few lines down, just magic, period.
I feel like Sal thinks magic is stupid and ridiculous, but like, he thinks monsters are super real.
Magic is fake, but monsters are real. Even though he has witnessed, you know,
some freaky bullshit.
Some freaky bullshit.
It's not magic, just monsters.
You found a demon portal, dude.
Magic is for children.
And like, he's like, no, magic is fucking for chumps.
Magic is for babies and their baby moms. That's exactly how Sal thinks it. This is a side RP that has happened with one of the other characters.
Magic is for
babies. So Sal, you hate monsters so much, but do you hate magic? Magic is for chumps and babies and their baby chump moms.
Wow, Sal. Rude.
It's canon.
Brought chat into the bathroom.
Why would I do that? I'm just kidding, this is water.
I was gonna say, because it sounds like somebody's carried
on. I'm not that gross. And when I do pee in the bathroom, I mute my mic.
Do you?
I also brought snacks.
And nuts, you mean?
You're well equipped.
No, I didn't bring nuts. What? I have goldfish.
And I have goldfish. Hello.
Wait, we gotta wait for the Inca doodles.
That's fine. Oh. I'm having my first food since lunch, so this is nice. Well, no. It's a popsicle.
I am having the opposite thing, and it's eating everything all day. Too much eating. Need to stop.
Jesus Christ.
Alright. I hope I find like deer tracks and little peg tracks and they're like having a track conversation.
I am returned.
Yeah, well.
South read the conversation tracks.
They're doing a little dance in the
they do a dance.
A little dance. Make a little long. Get down tonight.
Do the thing we did.
I'm doing my best to replace Shark, I'm sorry.
It's okay. Aww. I think we're all trying to contribute just a little.
Because we're missing our song
Shark
references.
Hey, when you listen to this, hey.
Hi, Shark.
Alright.
You better be quoting the funny shit in this place, because good lord.
Secret update master.
So, yes. So Sal rolled a successful track.
Mm. A critically successful track. So,
here's the earth. Around. Sal, you basically walk along the car and you're like, oh, and like your eye slits narrow to that of a cat. And you just see it.
You become the cat with hands.
Mm-hmm.
No! I hate all of you so much.
You'll never escape. Sorry.
I'm eating goldfish.
There you go, Sal. There is your destination.
No. Sal will point out that destination and say, go straight to this house.
Should we also perception as we, like, ride around that check out these?
Oh, yeah.
You may.
Damn.
Anderson's busy driving.
Beep beep.
Safe driving, Dad.
Good job, Sal.
Nice.
Or should I say, better job.
Did Tomo roll yet?
What am I rolling?
Roll perception, buddy.
Oh my god. I'm so sorry.
Tired?
You
did it, Tomo.
He's not dying. He's able to look and see things.
Look, Tomo. Look with your special eyes.
He's trying, okay?
Also, Jesus Christ, Sal.
Dang.
You keep getting so many crits.
Fuck, it's fueled by the hate for Omega.
Christ, he's determined to find this clock, man.
Henderson had zero, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Henderson's drive.
Mm-hmm. Henderson, you are driving like a good Samaritan.
So many stop signs in this neighborhood.
A lawful citizen.
Eyes on the road, hands it, what is it, 10 and 2.
What? It's not 10 and 2. It's like 4 and 8.
Is that the new driving
rhetoric? Yeah, it's 4 and 8 now, yeah.
Well, to me it's 10 and 2, okay?
It's gotta
factor in the minority here.
The old lemons. Just looking around. You've really never seen this part of town. There's actually a lot more houses here.
Yeah.
A good amount of them don't seem to be used much anymore, but you can definitely tell where some people live because they have their little, yards decorated and stuff.
Mm-hmm. They look at their cars parked in the mm-hmm. driveways and, you know, the lawns are trimmed.
Tomo. Similar thing. Looking around, you see a flamingo on a lawn. Calls to you. You're not sure why.
I thought you were just gonna say, you see a flamingo, and I'm like, what is it doing in Wisconsin?
No, just a flamingo on the lawn, you know, a lawn ornament.
Hmm.
You don't know why, it just seems welcoming. As if you knew it.
Sal will get out.
I call out to it with my mind.
Sal.
Yep.
You crit success.
Right.
You not only know exactly where Omega headed, you know that there's something off about that house. You know that no one lives there or hasn't lived there in a while. You can tell by the state of the house. You can tell because there is no car. You can tell because you saw the for sale lease.
So I will get out.
Additionally, though, as you guys are driving, you note as you pass, like, you guys gotta drive along here. You know, this general area.
Uh-huh.
And you get a good look at this house right there.
What?
And you're like,
that one?
That one right there.
Oh,
we're talking about this one?
Yeah, and you see a familiar car parked in front of it.
Aww.
Roll a memory.
What's memory again?
Intelligence
composure.
Mm-hmm. Always forget.
Damn.
Wow. That's to make up for all my crits.
Holy shit.
Sal, do you point this house out to everyone else if you're going or not?
Yeah.
Oh my god!
I forgot.
Jesus Christ.
The others don't really recognize it, but Tomo, you remember having to read illegible handwriting in that car?
Oh boy. The one it broke into. Oh boy, memories.
Or should I say it's more of a van, but...
Takes a mental note that this is now Helling's house.
I thought they were out on a mission. Oh, does he say, tell everyone that's telling tells?
Yeah, he might.
Or
yeah,
is Tomo keeping that to himself?
Yeah, he goes, yeah, that must be Helling's house.
I thought he was off on a mission with Garly.
Maybe they're out here.
Go to the building. Go to the building. Sal, go to the building.
What's happening? Where did we go?
We're going to Omega's house.
Where is Henderson driving is the important question.
Yeah, Sal went out back with the tracks.
Henderson wanted to go check out Helling's house, but okay. Sal screamed at him and he did not.
Henderson. Sal, would you
we
like
just
to
lost our token.
No?
Just resist the temptation. No.
It disappeared on me, so maybe I just need to refresh.
Hey, Inky. Would you like a voice on your side for going to Helling's place?
Okay, there we go.
Would you like a very persuasive player, Lemons?
Conspiracy against me.
Do it.
Do what Lemons would do.
Lemons wants to see Helling's house. Because he's not a creeper at all. What are you
talking
about?
Because he's so thirsty.
He's got that old man thirst.
Yeah.
So do I.
So while Sal's screaming about Omega's house, Lemon's like, oh, but we're never up here, and it'd be so, you know, interesting if we confirm that that's where, you know, one of our aces lives in case we need to find him later.
Hmm. Well, also, if he's around, we could update him.
Oh, right.
Sal's just like, all right, if we don't go, I'm just going to get out and go myself.
We'll follow up on that.
We're close enough. We'll meet back up at the car.
But the tracks. Wait.
Saying, come on, Sal. I'll go with you.
Oh, okay. All right. And Sal starts running the track, following the tracks.
So we park by Helling's?
We can park at the front of this. Because the street is short enough that we can...
Guys, we made the smart decision of splitting up.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No. We did!
Wait, who all went with Sal?
Well, Theo is going with Sal.
Oh,
I think Lemons and Henderson are going over to...
So where's Tomo going?
Well, Tomo noticed her, so...
Oh, yeah, he's gonna go to Helling's because he noticed it.
Oh god, you're leaving me to wrangle Sal.
Yeah,
I mean, that's gonna be...
Have
yeah,
fun.
You know exactly
well,
true. Job's gonna
well,
be
Henderson will
just
point
Omega.
Out that maybe two clubs at the place Omega's at might be a good idea.
Fighting
your
already big
for
dead.
What is
that cat?
That's
you guys can
cat?
Hear my cat.
Yeah. Song of his people.
Is that Boris?
No, it's Dash. That's Dash.
Oh.
All right, so...
Andrea, you can tell which cat, despite the cat noises?
Yeah. Dash right. is a loud one.
Alright, so you guys go to the house.
Secret door.
No, you could think go to Helling's house.
Thanks.
Tomo decides...
Look at his nice little fenced-in backyard.
He's a crappy house.
Tomo's going
wow, rude.
Freaking help with fucking Omega.
Alright, we're gonna deal
well, you
with...
gotta pick for yourself.
We're gonna deal with Team Helling's first, and then we'll deal with Team Omega. So,
I like how our teams are named after what we're facing off against.
No, Team Helling's is the one going to the Omega house. Alright, Henderson's gonna go up and knock on the door.
You, knock on the door. It's quiet for a bit. And then you hear, you know, thump, 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 and the door opens and Helling's looks at you. Yes. Wait.
Lemons will flash him his traditional Helling's smile for him.
Are you rolling for it or?
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh my god.
Of course I am.
Helling's worst nightmare. Lemons know where he lives now.
Oh my
Lemons
god.
Lemons knows where he lives.
Oh my god. You should have done willpower. Not all out.
Jesus Christ, Lemons. You've been holding on to them success.
I should have done willpower, but I don't know.
You can
know.
Still probably do it, can't you? Just do roll three more dice. Do it. Just melt him.
Nope.
Dang it.
What was that for?
That was willpower attacked on. It didn't add anything.
And what are you rolling for there?
It's my traditional hey, Helling. You know, the maybe vaguely
classic
flirtatious.
Sparkle.
Yeah.
This classic trademark Helling sparkle.
Sparkle.
Good evening, Mr. Lemons.
we're patrolling the checking the outer of the town. So we were just checking in to see if you had seen anything, and also we heard you were on a mission with Carly.
I was.
Both of you.
You kids. We just returned recently, actually. We didn't want to be out too late in case of unfortunate happenstances.
Oh, well, we found things.
Things?
Uh-huh.
Like, just tell me what
there was a hole in the ground by the cemetery that led to a tunnel. And then we also found a tunnel very purposely built into the old church out in the forest, which had a room with bleeding walls and witch occult worshipping stuff in it. So I just thought we could stop by and say to watch out for holes.
Good conclusion there. Yeah. You just watch out for holes.
Just kind of sneer on his face. It's just like, more of this than...
More...
What were you guys up to? Then?
We were scouting the area of the mimic establishment, if you will.
What? You were?
Well, if we're going to make a journey there, we don't want to be unaware of our surroundings.
Right.
Can I make a notice on Henderson?
A notice?
I want to make a notice on Henderson.
Empathy?
Nah, more of a notice.
Do it.
Fuck your empathy. I'm not... I don't want to do empathy.
Just trying to use different words so you can get a better roll.
Roll that
you
one
can roll a perception
dice.
If you want. Oh. Sure.
I want to do a perception out of empathy.
He has a nose.
Henderson. He seems pretty focused on this conversation.
Fine. Hey, you guys, fine.
Roll it.
I did it.
You have a minus one. You have a minus one because of his.
Fuck you.
Don't take this away from Lemon.
No, that would be a luck die, which would be not a 10.
Oh, wrecked.
Oh, no.
She used Henderson
willpower,
actually.
It is a mega.
Wait, why does he have a minus one?
Because of,
yeah.
Socially small?
That's okay, because I tacked on two dice as a willpower.
Oh, you dirty little. No, you gotta re-roll all of that then if you're gonna pull that card.
No, that's not fair. I think she earned that. No. That was smart. I like how Henderson, I feel like Henderson came out of the game and he was like, well, technically.
All right. You know what? We're gonna leave it to a player vote here.
I vote that
gets it. No, it's fine. He can trump me.
No.
Let the doable take over.
He transcends the game.
You know what? I'm gonna give it to you. Okay? What? I'm gonna give you your one success.
What? Is that okay with Inky?
Yeah. Henderson seems nervous. But you can't tell the unusual nervousness about it.
Right, other than
Henderson's always nervous.
Yeah, yeah.
You feel like the concept of anything involving the mimics has put him on edge.
Ah. Family and stuff like that, I guess. Okay, continue. I just wanted to do that desperate empathy. That's it.
I mean, Lemons always wants to know what people are thinking. So
I know, but it makes it fun. And very in character because Lemons really doesn't get
it's the
people.
Big joke though with Lemons, like we all know he can freaking seduce the shit out of everybody, but when it comes to knowing their feelings, oh god no.
Can I eat them? No. Why does it matter?
So, do they have feelings? Of course they don't.
Only guy has feelings.
So there's...
Sorry.
There's one at the graveyard and one at the church.
Yes, the graveyard looked like sort of maybe accidental, like a sinkhole type deal, but the church had like a secret sliding altar and everything, and it seemed pretty culty and also too big to fit under the church, which I will have to get back to that.
What?
I mean, I was just guesstimating, so it's possibly wrong.
Imagine if something needs to be under the church, it'd have to fit.
Yeah. Well, you talk about portals and stuff, so I'm just keeping open mind.
Yes, of course.
Kind of nods stiffly.
Crosses arms, looks at the rest of them. Any other reports?
There's some Omega tracks leading to one of the houses near here from the steel mill. So that's where we're going now, actually.
Want to come with?
Loaded question.
He kind of puts his
kill
hand.
Ones or be with Levens.
He kind of pinches the bridge of his nose.
No? Okay.
You're the worst, Lemons.
Give me a moment.
Oh my god.
Oh, okay.
He walks out. We're gonna switch now to the folks who are Team Omega.
Hey.
Ayo.
You guys. And that is Tomo, Sal, and
the Synagon.
Yes. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, I'm the Synagon.
Oh god, no. Get that out of here. Oh. It's not this dark, right?
Well, I mean, it's not super dark in the picture. It's cloudy. It is rainy and all that, remember?
It's a really nice looking neighborhood.
It's a residential street.
This is the neighborhood I was in.
Same picture, different neighborhood.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Well, percepti that house.
Yeah.
Yes.
God damn it.
Let's see what I can do. Whoa. Oh my god.
Oh, wait, no.
Henderson, why are you rolling up a
stool?
Oh, no. Henderson and him are having a moment.
Yep.
Oh. Dooble. Sal, you need to roll as well. Oh, you're good.
Okay. Oh, empathy competition between Lemons and Henderson.
Okay, I'm not gonna lie, that whole Dooble thing, that was seriously just unintentional, too. That's the worst part.
All right. Theo, you know, guys, you need to write it out, it's fine. Yeah. Theo and Tomo, you guys don't exactly know what you're looking for. Sal's really the one that's leading here. Sal, you come to this house. It is a very, very old house in comparison to everything else. There is what seems to be a shed in the backyard, as well as a very old, dying grass lawn. Very unwell. Unattended.
Rip.
No, that said, a lot of stuff is dying now. It's fall. But...
And librarians.
Oh no.
Fuck you.
Sal will try the front door.
Sal, you can't just walk in.
No one lives here.
Sal? You open the door.
Okay, Sal goes inside. Flashlight.
Are you serious?
Yes, he's very
Tomo's
serious.
Tomo's gonna look at him and be like, what if someone lives here, Sal?
No one lives here!
How do you know?
Come on, before he does anything stupid.
Can Sal point out, what did you say was the reason he knew people didn't live here again?
There's a four-lease sign in the front yard.
There's a for lease sign in the front yard.
Oh, that's a nice house.
Yeah.
Shakes head and goes in.
You come in and it's very old in here. Nicely decorated. It's almost out of a painting in a sense.
Sal's just kind of speedwalking around the house looking for Omega.
Oh my god.
All right, Sal, roll a perception as you speedwalk and look for Omega.
Jesus Christ.
He wants his blood.
Oh my god,
Jesus
Sal.
Christ, you better not.
Sal, you find what seems to be a bedroom, kitchen, dining room. No signs of Omega. What is this?
Backyard.
I was actually about to go there. You peer out the window into the backyard with your four successes. And you see what seems to be a very big tree back there.
Seeing the tree. Is there like a...
You don't know how old the tracks are.
Oh, I thought I had recognized they were like more recent.
Well, you just saw tracks.
Oh my fucking god. Whatever, you can still get stuff here from him being here. That's still important anyway, so it's fine. I actually should have probably looked to see where it went from the back, so that's what I'm gonna go look at now. Because I knew it came to the house, but I didn't see like where. Like, did it go to the backyard and go up the tree?
You don't know.
Wait, but the tracks didn't double back, so that's why I assumed that. Well, I guess I didn't ask.
You know that the tracks came here. You can make another survival check if you'd like.
I want to do that. I made the silly assumption of not. I did the same thing on the last one.
What are you rolling?
He's rolling. Oh, yeah. He's trying to track. You notice the tracks come to the front of the house, and then you have trouble seeing them as it reaches the deck.
He walked on it with his little pointy feeties.
Well, I guess he will. And there's no, like, doubling back of the tracks?
Not that you can tell. They stop at the deck.
Well, Sal will point that out and say there's no... The tracks, even if they are old, they're not doubling back or anything. So that means when one direction, they came either went a different direction or he just didn't come back ever.
Well, what's the other side of the deck? Like, if we follow the deck towards where it wraps around the house, where does it come out?
Yes,
it leads into the house.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Maybe you can transform into a kid. Well, are the tracks going... Do I know if the tracks are going towards the house or away from the house?
Towards the house.
Okay, I was making sure.
Check the other doors.
Yeah.
If it came in and then left somewhere else. Can we do a more thorough look around the house than Sal's like brisk walk through?
Yeah.
If you'd like to, you may.
Sure.
I'll do that too.
Okay, Kareem. Okay, go ahead. I'll speak when things are done.
No, go ahead. What did you want to say, Nick?
Kareem, when you said, what if he could transform into a kid? First thing that came to mind was, you're a clock now, you're a kid now.
God damn it.
Sorry. I had to interrupt for that.
Fox squids.
It wasn't worth it.
Do you want a Percepti too?
Yeah. Whoa. God damn it.
Sorry, Tomo.
I can't see anymore. I'm blind.
You are now Jason.
Transformation complete.
And three successes. Theo, yes?
Yes.
What are you looking for? Or just a general perception?
Just general perception around the house.
Looking around the house, you can tell there's only one bedroom, but it seems to have a double bed inside of it.
Hmm.
have the main area. A lot of the stuff is very old antiques. Like, you thought your place was granny style.
Super granny style.
This one's worse. You find a door that leads to a basement. You can see the stairs leading down. But it is not lit up down there.
Mm. Should we check it out?
Yes.
Shh, don't worry about it, it's fine.
Yeah, we can.
Well, Sal votes yes.
Yeah, Sal goes. He doesn't vote.
Oh, God.
Alright, Sal, so you're going down the stairs?
Yes, flashlight out.
Alright, Sal. You walk down the stairs. While you walk down the stairs, I'm going to switch to the other group. And just leave it on the house picture because I freaking can. So, Hellings comes out. Wow. You know, he's got his coat back on. He looks like he does not want to be here right now.
You don't have to come if you don't want to.
Nonsense.
Oh, okay.
Adventure lies.
That's the end of the discussion.
You can probably just walk over too.
Yeah.
Across the backyard, literally.
Yeah, can probably. Yeah, it's like literally just tiny little trees separating. So Henderson could probably point out the trail they followed.
Or just point over to if one of them is the house. You can probably see the house.
Well, no, I mean he wants to show them the tracks as well.
Oh, right.
Like, to prove that it's Omega tracks.
Yeah.
And how close does Omega, like, get to Hellings' house?
Yeah.
Well, you see Hellings' house on there, and you see the little red dots, so...
I don't look at it because I'm on the house page.
Oh, right. Page. It's not too terribly. It's at least half a block down.
Okay.
Okay.
I forgot I left you kids on the house page.
Let's go over to the house.
Go to the house. Go to the house. You go to the house.
Yeah.
You join the others at the house as Sal goes down to the basement.
Oh, yay. Sal's good history with stairs.
I was gonna say, doesn't this look familiar, Sal?
isn't this
the same picture?
Yes, it is. I do believe it is.
Well, that's good.
Well, that's where you found the dead body of your ghost hunting lady
friend.
This is
when those things. This is when those things were chasing him and Jason, and then he jumped out the window, and then he caught Jason.
Sal is the coolest guy.
Yeah, he's probably super cool. He tried punching the ghost. I remember that.
Yeah, it didn't work. It's just in. You can't punch ghosts.
The ghost is like WTF.
Right.
I love how that sounded like a question, just we can't punch ghosts?
I'm sure there are some hunters who have tried really hard and found a way.
Sal will continue to go down.
Alright.
We're following Sal. Flashlights out. Theo has the walkie-talkie and phone ready.
Christ.
Actually, he will radio back that we found a basement, and Sal went down, so we're going with him.
Sounds very familiar to the last situation.
Wait, we're coming. Hellings is with us. Please wait, please.
Sal will continue to go down the stairs.
We can radio,
Sal.
You know.
Lemon says over radio.
Sure, and then it's like, hey, we're on our way with Hellings.
No, he'll kill Steel.
Sal's kill stealing. He's gone. He wants to see it.
Are you listening to the radio, Sal, or are you still going down the stairs?
Oh, Sal's going down the stairs.
He's being stubborn, so
Tomo's following after him while trying to explain what's going on.
He's being stubborn, so we're gonna go down. We'll meet you. The door is open. You don't have to. Oh.
Does he say that?
Yeah, he just trails off as they get to the bottom of the steps.
Get down. It's very, very dark.
Is it three, like, roll percent?
Really pixely, or is it just like
in real life?
Not loaded.
It's pixely. I couldn't do better.
It's pixely in real life.
Cool. Okay, I wanted to know if it was just my computer.
It's pixelated in real life.
Jesus Christ.
Do we roll perception or?
I'm gonna.
You maybe.
Damn. Aw.
Oh, you can do it. You can do it, Tomo. You can do it.
One. One.
Theo, you're in just total shock. You don't know why. It's just a basement. Just a.
God.
It's just
it's
an exposed basement. Mm. Huh. That's fine. Nothing bad can happen here. Tomo. It's definitely not mine's. It has a similar aesthetic, but it doesn't feel like the same. Sal.
Yeah.
This basement continues on. There's more.
Sal continues on because there's more.
And as you get closer, you...
Someone's
at it again. That isn't me.
Oh, okay. I was actually scared.
It was not me.
Inky's known for this.
It is not
But it's
me,
not Inky. But it's not Inky.
It's Andrea, then.
Came from inside
not
the house.
Me.
It's not me. I'm telling
Angie.
You that. Whoa. Somebody booped.
Gigs up,
somebody
Andy.
Did booped.
That was me. I'm my headset.
And you like. Continue forward. And as you do, it gets closer and closer. You know, the walls narrow in. And they change to more natural materials.
Uh-oh.
Oh, well, jeez. Sal gestures towards it, and he's like, I told you.
Theo grabs the back of Sal's shirt and starts trying to pull him away. He's like, nope, no, we're going back upstairs and we're waiting.
Tomo is going to be like, Kareem?
Kareem, get back here. Sal is just me.
Tomo's going to look at Sal and be like, we don't know if this leads to the mines or not. We need to be careful.
Sal will back up begrudgingly.
What, are we caught up yet?
Yes. You guys enter the house.
Okay.
Okay.
Can we give perceptions around the house, see if we see anything the others didn't?
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yes, closed door behind us. Trap Hellions in the house with you, Lemons.
No! 1980s.
Hellings opens the door, walks out.
I'm going home.
Curses. He's too powerful.
I'm going home.
Doors cannot stop him. Alright, so if we don't see anything interesting, we'll head down. Oh.
Alright, type out your perceptions, please.
Whispers. Two. Is that in the house, those whispers?
That is what Sal and them in the basement are hearing.
Oh, okay.
No.
I didn't hear it. I gotta make it louder.
Wait, what?
I thought it was triggered by our perception roll, so.
No, oh, no. Theo is more insistently pulling on Sal's shirt and
Sal
trying
saying,
to back them up.
Wait, I told you the clock was evil.
Wait, do these sound familiar?
These whispers?
Yeah, like mimic whispers?
Mimics can sound like all kinds of things, Tom.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good point.
No. Do they sound like anything that we've already seen before, like anything in the mimic cave? That's what I meant.
Try and roll a memory. Henderson, Lemons, and Hellings is following behind you. You guys look around and you see basically the same thing. You have no idea, Tomo. You guys see basically the same thing as before. As the others, I mean. Such a nice, quaint house. It'd be hard to notice the terrible things that lie beneath it.
The E.
And you guys hear unhappy Theo noises coming from the basement, consisting of Sal, no, let's go back.
We should get down.
Yeah.
Henderson hustles his hoofies.
I just imagine Sal's like blankly looking into it, and Tomo or Theo's just pulling really hard, and he's like,
well,
hanging
Tomo's
off of
not
him.
Pulling him. He's just straight up being Theo, like, Sal, yeah. Just wave.
No, Theo's like... got his shirt, and he's like, come on, come on. And Sal was like digging his heels in. He probably doesn't even have to dig his heels in. He's just standing there.
He's just being reasonable because he doesn't know if this leads to the mines or not. Because it just suddenly switched over to natural cavern.
It wasn't suddenly. It was a slow change.
Mm. Hey, we're coming down.
Hellings, Hellings pulls out his axe from under behind his coat.
Sal will say. Yeah, it's back in his pants. Sal will say as they come down, I told you the clock was evil. He gestures towards the cavern. And the whispers, if they notice, start noticing it.
Everyone down there can hear.
Yeah.
The whispers.
I mean, just living near something spooky doesn't make you evil, or you would all be evil.
The tracks led directly to this house. And they don't leave the house.
Are we all together now?
Might mean that it leads somewhere. Yes.
It could be exit by the graveyard. Maybe that's how it gets around town without being seen.
Is it, like, darkness in front of us?
Yes.
Well, I mean, we all have flashlights, so...
Well, yeah.
Can we flash our
light? Our powers combined!
Zoom?
Form of giant... flashlight.
What we need is like those little like balls of light that you can just roll down.
Oh, the light globes?
Yeah. We need to invest in those.
I'm surprised nobody has drawn Keshar cat's smiley face. Like the darkness.
Do we see anything else or is there still darkness beyond our flashlights?
You don't see much. It seems to continue on.
I think we should make sure. Keep an eye on your phone clock.
Yeah,
though.
I was about to have Lemons do that, actually. He'll actually peek at his clock right now.
You look at your clock, and it reads around 5:30.
When is curfew again?
Or it's like more like 5:15. Curfew's usually 7.
Okay. Sundown.
We have an hour and a half, and worst comes to worst, sleepover at Hellings. And he says that out loud.
Hellings looks at you with distaste.
Sal looks at them and he's like, onward?
Are we really doing this?
Tomo pulls out his axe and he's like, I guess so.
Sal starts walking forward.
Right.
With Theo still attached to his
yeah.
I feel like it should be like clubs in front, clubs in back, everyone squishy in the middle.
That's a good idea. Hellings will probably stay in the back then. Unless
probably club
in front,
club in middle, club in back.
A club for every
you're
other
clubbing
person.
You're clubbing everywhere.
Well, it's Sal, Theo, Tomo, Henderson, Lemons.
Yeah, it's a club per person.
Yeah.
Actually, no, except two. No, that's a club.
Oh, Henderson is.
What are clubs?
Henderson could kill both the clubs if he wanted to. Is the club dead also? He is the club and the spirit.
Please, Hellings, kill both the clubs. We don't want them. None of our creators want them.
Wow.
Oh my god.
Calm down.
Mean. Henderson has the high power flashlight, so he can lead. And then that gives the clubs, you know, alternating backwards.
Alright. You guys walk on either side. And you walk for a while. These whispers don't seem to be coming from anywhere specific.
Can Henderson keep a mental map of where they should be around town using direction sense?
You may try. I'm going to have you roll a intelligence academics. I'm going to give you +2 for direction sense.
Okay. Well, you know, this is important. He will spend power on that. Which is one third worse. There I go.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Brain dead, good brain.
The eagle emerges from a hole.
Your fucking brain is huge, Henderson.
Wait, what is he doing?
Yeah, well, he will power that, so.
Henderson, you guys arrive in a deeper room.
Mm.
It's not a spooky room at all.
As you do, you notice in the back of your mind's eye or whatever, an eagle comes to visit you. And for a moment, the whispers are quiet. As it comes to you, and it whispers into your ear.
Ah. Oh, I thought you were going to go, bah! Like, really loud.
I thought you were going to play the sound.
Oh.
Yes, and it whispers into your ear, Henderson.
Could we have
this? I like how it's named Critical Success Eagle.
And by doing this, you gain all the knowledge. You know that you are heading back in a direction that would lead towards the old steel mill.
Okay. Can we have the tunnels drawn on the town map afterwards?
Sure.
For my crit success? Yay!
Oh.
Genuine happy.
And you guys enter this area. However, I'm afraid to say, the eagle could not blot out the whispers for long.
Oh, they're back. Everyone notices they were gone for a little bit.
No, it was only Henderson.
I know.
Is there like a certain direction where they're coming from? Or is it just echoing?
Echoing.
Mm.
And I would actually like everyone to roll a perception.
Dang it.
Oh my god.
Dude, your life sucks.
I'm terrible. I feel like I need to throw more dots into this.
More dots.
That's what I've been doing.
More dots.
I think I might stop have dots. One dot.
Off my composure and my wits just because of that.
That's rude. At least take one out on a dinner first.
Oh my god. Oh my god, Inky.
One.
Are we missing anyone?
Nope.
We're missing Shark.
Oh, Henderson's is below. Okay, sorry.
Yeah.
Alright. Tomo, it's just so incoherent to you. You can't make out what it's saying. Theo, you feel like you pick up words here and there, like her. But you can't make a complete heads or tails of it. Now, Henderson, Sal, and Lemons, you get a complete sentence out of it.
Hello.
Nothing.
That's a sentence.
Oh. Yeah.
Secret messages for Shark.
Someone's intently typing. He's laying down the keyboard.
Yeah, she's giving us a complete sentence.
Wow! Wait, man. A complete sentence.
It just goes from, like, silent typing to just...
Is this water on the floor?
Nah.
Yeah, okay, it looks like reflective.
Are those pipes? Break the pipes! Break the pipes! This was her home, where she lived, where she saw and controlled. Hey, you're up.
Do these things on the wall, they're like bricked up X windows or X like hiding spots or?
Something bricked up. You're not sure what.
Henderson will go knock and see if it's like solid brick or if there's still holes behind it.
There seems to still be holes behind it. It feels hollow.
You got two clubs with two axes.
Sal looks down. Oh.
Can't punch bricks either, Sal.
You can't tell me what to do! Punches the
brick. Punch the orphanage. I think it can punch a brick wall.
And I got like a crit success. I
to punch it. A house.
You shook the orphanage.
Well, should we check them out or just let them be?
Yes.
And Link's ready his axe. There's nothing to lose.
Oh boy. Lemon stands back.
Okay, let's go. You go.
Oh.
Yokosuke. Put that new axe of yours to use, will you?
I just imagined I imagined him like picking his nose, like, huh?
Casually looks up. What?
Where? Okay, out of character. Where? What exactly is happening? I completely missed.
These two bricked-up areas are hollow.
Oh yeah, he'll take one and go over.
Wouldn't that mess up the axe?
Mine's metal.
And you can always sharpen
it. It will blunt it a little bit, but yeah.
Depending on what type of axe it is, usually they have the counterbalance side that's blunt. You can kind of smash with that.
Oh yeah, the little like pick side.
Yeah. So he's gonna go up to one of these and.
Wow, Hellings, you're embarrassing yourself.
It's not going so well.
He does it. Everyone just kind of awkwardly coughs. I'm just getting ready.
Strength brawl.
Strength weaponry.
Okay.
Oh, shoot, I forgot to add the axe in.
What do I get for axe? Plus one or plus two?
Plus two, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, I think axes are 2L.
Hey, you wanna... There you go, happy. See? Tomo's keeping up.
Knows what he has to do. He's gonna do it.
Alright, are you hitting the same one or are you going to the others?
He's going to the other one.
Alright. You guys get the lovely chunk of axes hitting a stone, and he will hit it again. Ah, it's just not going well today.
Meanwhile, Tomo isn't complaining.
Roll again, Tomo.
Oh, we're doing it again?
Well, it's an extended roll. You're not just getting it.
Wait,
one
so there's
cup.
Does it? It still goes down, right? Like it's another dark path or whatever.
Yes.
Okay, Sal will kind of peer through there with his flashlight while they're breaking it.
You peer through, and what you see is what seems to be a hallway almost identical to this one.
What are these mimics?
No, keep the eyes there.
Punch it. Punch it.
Uh-oh.
Give me a smiley face.
No smiley faces.
Aww.
Just two little glowing. Oh, man, you're
guys,
right, whoever added the frown.
Guys, I don't want to be a mimic.
I just want to love.
You find those in the next hall. So. Just
okay.
Two beady little eyes.
Which hall is it? Is it mine or Hellings?
Can I not see the beady
Neither.
Eyes?
Neither. It goes straight. You and Hellings are in the previous one, hitting the walls.
You guys are here and here.
Mm-hmm.
So I used my flashlight, and I couldn't see what it was, just the eyes?
It seems to be a shifting darkness.
Sal will relay the information of the shifting darkness eyes. There are shifting darkness eyes in here.
What? Sounds like a wisp.
Oh.
How do you kill a wisp again?
You just kill it.
It's not like a ghost. Like
I
you don't go through it.
I thought ghosts didn't come out until nighttime.
Well, it's dark enough down here that. Well. It's probably pretty safe.
Is it close
for
enough?
It. Are you gonna? It's on like the other end of the room.
Nah, it's not. It's not worth it. There's probably like a bunch of them in there.
Should we be staying down here?
Yes.
collect these and then head up.
Okay.
So I'll just keep an eye in that room, I guess, because I don't think it's going to come towards the light.
I mean, as you should... If you keep your light shined on it, Sal, it does not seem to leave that door.
Okay. Yeah, I guess we'll just wait for you guys to break that down then. Ah, that actually scared me.
Oh, jeez.
That actually scared the crap out of me.
What happened?
Who drew that? Was that Bree?
I did not do that.
roll again, Toma.
What happened?
Do you not see that?
No.
Look closer.
Holy shit.
It's the worst scary.
Oh, okay, I see it.
It's so much scarier. I don't trust this. I'm Xing it out. I don't trust you.
I will clear your drawings. Oh, I hate that gif and I hate you.
Is it a jump scare?
No, I've seen the original video in which it's from, though, and it scared the piss out of me.
Oh, it's a good thing. It's a good thing I X'd it out, because I don't trust you. I don't trust you, Inky.
Alright, so... And yeah, Inky, that's pretty much it. Tomo, you managed to break yours down just as Helling's breaks his down, and through the crumbling of stone... You don't hear much, so... It gets just very loud for a moment, the sound of tumbling rocks, all that. Sal, you hear that behind you. A loud clatter. What do you do?
Scared, not turning around. Sal is keeping
him.
Way on the way.
Why behind him?
Because he went
the
ahead
The rocks just came down.
I didn't
Sal
go ahead. I'm still
well,
in the
room. Well, I thought you were at the doorway looking into the next room.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm not.
So
I'm not...
you're a little further forward. Like, Sal is oh, right boy. Here. Tomo is here. Hillings is here.
The
yes.
Sal looks like a little snake.
Yeah, he even looks like it has fangs.
Alright, so...
I'm doing something quick. I'll put it back. Sorry. So it's okay.
Scared.
I'm scared. Triggered.
I realized I was mute. It'll
be okay.
Oh, no.
Don't put it off. I'm triggered.
Sal, your flashlight flickers for a second.
Yep, alright. I have a backup flashlight, it's fine. Sal takes out his other flashlight.
Take out your other flashlight.
Yeah. Okay, you scared me. I thought something was gonna show up.
And Tomo and Hellings, you guys break it, and there seems to be these sarcophagus-like holes in the wall.
No.
And
no!
There are two very small coffins.
Oh no!
Oh no.
Oh jeez. These look children-sized.
They look very children-sized.
Oh no.
Oh look, it's Omega. We did it.
I solved the mystery, guys.
Now let's burn their corpses.
No!
That's not how you burn? Make friends with a ghost.
Burn? No, Sal. I'm
just gonna leave that alone.
Are
there any...
What's inside? I don't think the others can see since you guys are in front of the holes.
Hellings takes a step back so that everyone can see inside.
Oh!
Tomo does too, so that other people
shine a flashlight in and perception.
You may.
Yeah!
Oh,
jeez.
Double high
five. On children.
Double high five, Henderson.
Wait, what are you rolling?
Henderson, with the mere mention of children, his eyes hone in.
Am I doing that too?
Yeah, and everyone can.
If you want to look.
I can.
They bashed open the bricked off parts and they found tiny child sized sarcophagi.
Oh, looking in there, rescind my roll.
Sure.
I take it back.
Lemons nopes out.
Yeah. Oh.
Lemons ain't
helpful.
Tomo's
doesn't
gonna
exist. Lemons doesn't
Tomo's gonna look at his.
Because Lemons is, away from over there.
Do you see the hand?
I feel like Sal would see that.
Do you see?
I feel like.
Yeah, Sal, you see it.
Yeah, Sal's like, we need to get out. We need to go right now. We need to leave. We need to not be here.
Tomo's gonna turn.
Sal's like freaking out and like we need to run. That's sort of alarming.
Do we get any?
Oh, Jesus. All right,
now Sal turns around. He doesn't turn around. He keeps the light on. He's like trying to move them back though. Like he's backing up with the light at the wall. And he's like, take out your lights. Let's go. Leave now.
Oh, God. Oh dear.
He's gonna pull out his axe and kind of back up next to Sal. So like he's backing up with him, but he sits like standing next to him.
Did we get anything from looking in, or did we get?
What's the time on my phone say?
Phone says it's around.
Or is it freaking out?
It's around 7.
Oh.
Oh.
It's not been that long.
Time to go, guys.
I said keep an eye on your clock. All right, time to go.
Yeah, but then people got distracted by kids. Did we manage to see anything?
It was Lemon's job. Yes.
Blame Lemons for it.
Oh God!
I wasn't aware that an hour and a half had passed.
We gotta move!
We are going to move! We're just waiting to hear the result from our roll!
Did you guys type out? No, we rolled and then everyone immediately noticed hands. So we all freaked the fuck out.
Good.
So Henderson and Theo are looking at the one Hellings broke open, and then Tomo's looking
over here.
Uh-oh.
Are those from the ground?
Oh, Jesus, yeah, they are.
Mm. Alright, is that everyone's roles? And are those perceptions? Yes.
Yes.
Lemons rescinded because he was looking at his phone. You guys looking in, these are very, very ancient looking sarcophaguses made out of nice wood, rotting, of course. And they're not opened, bolted shut, it looks like, actually. To get a better look, you feel like you'd have to take them out.
Don't got time for that.
Yep, Tomo ain't dealing with that. He's gonna get over and...
Tomo, the one you're looking at is bigger than the other.
Don't matter, he's gonna back
wait,
up.
So are these hands that Sal has seen before?
Yeah.
What?
You remember a couple of these just reaching under doorways and such in the orphanage.
Oh great. You're like that memory. That killed all my acquaintances.
Not matriarch per se.
Yeah, but still things that killed things.
Jesus Christ, they're coming out of everything.
Sal is severely triggered and terrified.
So what do you do?
You're gonna go.
Yeah. Tumble's out.
Sal, back
especially,
up.
Especially... Oh.
What is that? What is that?
We need to move!
The hand coming right for you.
That's a thing right in the front of the camera where Lemons is gone by.
All right, are you guys running?
Yeah, we going. I'm going.
All right, I'm gonna. Nice eyes, 10 out of 10.
Hey.
I'm gonna need you guys to roll a stamina athletics to run.
We should take residence in Helling's house.
He still brings that cheeky crap up at the end.
No!
Oh, Tomo.
No!
Oh my God, Sal.
Sal's not gonna run ahead anyway, though, so it's kind of wasted.
I mean, his willpower.
Transfer some success.
Ayo, I'm legging it.
Lemons is fucking out. Type your successes.
Lemons will gladly stay in the front.
Bitch, I'm out.
Oh, sorry, I have 6 too. But, yeah.
Okay. Is that everyone? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
With my roll, Am I able to kind of usher Theo along?
I would allow it.
All right, Sal wants to do the same thing with Tomo. Okay. He's not, yeah. He wants to do that with, and he makes, he's not going to leave anyone behind, so I'll stay in the back and kind of using his role, I guess, to speed up other people.
Tomo, you were about to run, you know, you started the stuff, you're like, no! And as you turn too quickly and trip, but Sal comes by and he's like, bye, and picks you up. And you guys hoof it. You hoof it up the stairs, past all the crap you've seen. I'm gonna need a perception as you're running.
If perception slows me down, I'm not gonna perceive.
Oh, of course, I get 2 on my perception, but I don't get 2 on my stamina. Nope.
See, like I said, if perception slows me down, I'm not perceiving. I ain't perceiving, I'm running.
He doesn't even care, he just knocks things over and runs out. You just hear faint. Oh, sorry.
Bye.
We'd have to turn the Helling's porch light on, too.
I'm sure it's on automatically, one of those things. I mean, I have one of those. I'm sure he has one in this town.
The motion activated lights.
Or just the time activated
lights. Timed light.
The Cardian house.
You guys sprint.
Well, the Cardian's house is old. Oh, buddy.
Is there lights in the house?
We got some friends.
Like, is there light switches?
It hasn't been used in a while. No one's paid power.
Bye. Dang. That's a good point.
Bye.
Yep, running!
I'm leaving.
I'm gonna need another roll. Almost everyone has 2 low successes to pay attention to anything right now.
Another perception
or athletics?
Oh my
athletics.
God.
Willpower again.
Is there any way I could slap a willpower onto that?
I hope you already rolled.
One's okay. One is okay!
Hey, we're bugging it.
That's good.
Dude. Tomo is the one helping.
Oh my god, you only have 2 dice for running.
Who?
Lemons.
Yeah.
Alright.
I gotta put something in athletics.
Lemons, Theo.
Stamina. That'd
Lemons and Theo, you guys make it out of the house. You are running down the street all the way towards Helling's house. Yep. There is no chill.
Keep going.
Sal, as you're running up the stairs, a hand comes from in between the spaces and grabs your ankle.
Sounds dead.
due to the fact that you were trailing next to Henderson, you falling causes Henderson to trip up as well.
Ah, no fair, don't make me the cause.
It's not you, it's the spoopy thing that got you.
But and you said it me caused it, that makes me feel bad.
Take 1 lethal. Oh, as it feels like fire rings around your ankle.
Sorry, Henderson.
Tomo is gonna try and cut that hand off of Sal's ankle.
Okay.
He's by the wrist.
Please don't cut his ankle off.
Yeah.
Sal gets a cool prosthetic foot.
That'd be cool. Sal thinks about that.
Hey, dibs?
Oh yeah. I'm gonna roll right now if that's okay.
After you roll that, Anderson will get a quick C action and we're gonna go to initiative.
Oh boy.
Oh yeah.
Sal, you no longer have to worry about a hand on your foot.
That's good.
No, not you, Lemons, you're fine. Those who are currently dealing with Shadow Friends.
Oh, okay.
Unless we go back in.
Nope.
You cut the hand and it disappears into what seems like mist. That's
That's a shitty roll. That's a real shitty roll right there.
Got some good shit.
It's the best shitty roll I ever had.
Good shit. That's some good shit.
Sal, you got a shitty roll.
That's some good shit right there.
You're gonna get yourself a kill, Sal.
Oh dang, that's a good roll.
Oh no.
Oh no.
I almost put 89 for Henderson's. He's gone.
Henderson has rocket feet.
He has rocket spine. Achoo! Oh, just a loud crack.
God. Does the fifth dot cost more than the other dots? Oh wait, that's not what I meant. That's not what I meant at all. I don't know why I asked that. Never mind.
Out of everything you could have said for Rocket, I didn't expect Rocket Spine, and the laugh that I made really hurt my throat. Ow.
Oh.
Oh no.
Nope.
We're gonna be
Gosh
dead.
Gosh darn it.
We're dead.
It's fine. It's only gonna be a bunch of people there. Who's the idiot who decided to go down there?
It was yourself.
Wow.
Wow,
you know, I wonder if it's almost the guy who ran down the stairs.
Yeah, you know, I guess we would've been perfectly fine if we killed the stupid clock.
You know, it'd be fine if you didn't just go down the stairs.
It would've been fine to kill this stupid clock.
God bless. I like how it sounded like you were fading away, like... in the background, kill a stupid clock. wander away into the distance.
What's your defense, Henderson?
His defense is 3.
You see more hands come out from the basement as they try to grab you. Take one lethal as one wraps around your ankle, just as Sal's had. Yeah. It's like, these are different than the ones in their house. They hurt a lot more.
Last night was bashing.
Yes, it was.
Can you flash a light at these
They're
things?
They're stronger.
You can try to, on your initiative.
Wait, but out of curiosity, just because I can't remember right, how did I interact with light again?
Wisps avoid it.
Toma, what's your defense?
2.
If they absolutely need to, they will go into light, because, in order to escape.
Happy birthday, lethal son, it has you too.
Oh no. Oh no, guys.
You don't know how one somehow managed to get its hand around your throat, but...
Well, we're dead.
Oh, healed already.
Tomo, it's your turn.
Yeah, he's gonna shine a light on him.
Alright. Roll, I think we've been doing Dex firearms.
Yep.
Being that they're coming out of every crevice, it's going to be difficult to get all of them.
Shot with the light, and you're too flame.
This is why you just carry floodlights around.
Henderson has
one installed on the top of the RB.
That was not my role. I didn't
turn that on, people who are running.
That was not my role. I didn't even put my die number in there.
We should probably head to the RV first instead of Helling's house, because if he locked the door, we're not getting in.
Oh my god,
Henderson
you're right.
Turn on the floor.
Yeah, shit. Henderson
we're
has
not
the
getting
keys.
Into the car either.
God, oh my god, dude.
You're just running
You shine it on the one on yourself, and it lets go with a hiss.
Oh, good.
I'll get you next time, Gadget.
But another one takes his place.
Another one bites the dust.
Another lethal as you shine it on the other one, but you leave a shadow in the other place, and it seems like they're just spawning from them.
Oh, shit. We gotta move.
That's why you just burn the house down.
It feels like it's reaching right through you.
Do I have a lighter?
Sal, you're up.
Do I have a lighter?
I don't know, do you?
I really hope I have a lighter.
Let's see.
I feel like burning down the house is a perfect idea.
Is it in your equipment?
But just release them into the world.
It's fine.
You have a flashlight, a supernatural tracking device, a portable radio, no lighter.
Well, I do have a flashlight, and flashlights, if you break it and you put it, you light it properly.
Don't
what I roll
break
for
your
that?
Flashlight, Sal.
You can roll a, I would say, dex crafts to try and make a fire with your flashlight.
So,
I'm going to give you -1 for improvisation.
Okay, I'm also going to use willpower then. That's going to be 7.
Go.
Oh, the 5 is not there though. But yeah, that's still awesome.
Re-roll those 10s.
This house is going to be lit on fire real quick.
This is lit right now.
Oh my
god. God damn it.
That's 8. Oh, that's 9 successes.
What the fuck, Sal?
To burn
9.
The house down.
Sal, you know what you must do. They say when you are young that arson is the way to go.
I almost got double the eagle.
You almost got twice the eagle.
You almost landed a double eagle.
Is it a move
double
now?
Double eagle all the way.
That's how lands the eagle. Almost the double eagle. Oh, but he falls.
He falls just short.
Oh, but he trips over the final hurdle.
So, you take your lighter, and you do exactly what no one would have ever guessed to do with a lighter. Or not a lighter, sorry, a flashlight, and that's to make it a lighter. So, you take your flashlight, and you take the closest flammable thing you can possibly think of, which is Tomo's jacket, and...
rips it off Tomo.
He ain't even wearing one!
Oh, jeez. You set fire. You set fire to this house, and to make it burn like no house has ever burned before.
I like to imagine his eyes have the fire in it.
Oh, God.
Like, reflected.
See, the thing you didn't think about, though, is old houses like these, they can be matchboxes.
Oh,
full of asbestos.
You're still in it. I'm gonna need you guys to roll a dex athletics to try and get out. As okay. quickly
Henderson
this thing spreads.
Still like, grappled by that.
As soon as the first flame comes up, it lets go.
Hey, it was a totally stupid idea.
Okay,
what
yes,
you
yes,
say?
Yes,
you guys run as fast as you can as the house goes up in flames. And you make it outside. As you look back and what was left of it is nothing but embers as it goes up so fast. As if it was meant to be.
Oh boy.
Oh.
She was ready.
You are now outside at night.
Yeah, let's house, please.
Yeah, probably.
I think Lemons and Theo are already probably at the door.
Wait, was Hellings with you guys?
Yes, Hellings is with them.
Is the RV anywhere near here?
Oh yeah, Henderson has the keys.
I think you parked the RV nearby, yes.
Yeah, it's parked at the top of the block.
Yeah, Tomo's booking it for the RV.
By the RV, they can still get at it.
No, but wait! Helling's house is right around the corner.
Well, yeah, he's just gonna follow Helling's. I mean, Sal's the slowest one here, so.
Oh, yeah, I guess I'll go follow Helling's and didn't realize him.
You guys run ahead. I'm gonna need you to roll your running checks one more time, as being outside at night is quite the dangerous thing.
For everyone?
No! Those of you.
Sal will wait for
son of a bitch.
He'll use his successes with Tomo and
stay son
back.
Of a bitch. Why, when it
Sal,
matters the most?
Or not Sal, Tomo, you missed your check, and as you do, Hellings picks you up and literally heaves you over his shoulder.
Oh, Hellings is there.
Hellings
Why
got
the
it.
Fuck? When every single time I need a roll, it just says no. Oh, that makes
dramatic
me
dramatic fodder.
That makes me upset because I feel like I'm being carried by the
zero
team literally every time.
On four dice isn't that unusual. But you do really well when you attack stuff.
But when I need to run.
You're more athletics or stamina. Or not stamina, dexterity. Isn't just bolting strength?
The straight
up. Yeah, but extended running is stamina.
Oh, okay.
Oh god, they're crawling out of the burning house.
Oh,
oh
god.
God. We're not watching, we're at Helling's house now.
Yeah, no. You guys get one nice look back beforehand. And you get a nice dose of trauma. And then you get inside.
Flick the light on if it isn't on.
Yeah. Did we have to roll anything for waiting? Or were we good?
You see, I thought you guys were already running.
We were.
So I assumed you got there before everyone else.
Yes.
And
but
just
they
went inside.
The key to the house.
Hmm?
They don't have the keys to the house.
The door's not locked.
Hey!
Smarty, smarty pants.
Hello. Whoa!
He kind of rushed him out of his own home.
We abducted him.
And look how good that was, because if we hadn't, we would have had to wait for him to open the door, and he wouldn't have been there to pull Tomo out.
Nope. Well, if the door is open, we're in and turning on lights, then. Yep.
You're inside.
So when you guys come running in, everything's all lit up already.
Get lit.
Not the fire kind of way.
Just... So we're all in there, breathing heavily, probably. Sounds like, and that's why you kill the clock.
I don't think the clock has anything to do with that.
That had nothing to do with the clock,
the time?
So.
The time?
Not the wisps. Were dying from the inside of the house, from the creatures inside.
But that,
can we not fight about this right now, please?
Helen slams the door behind you all, locks it, turns on like all the lights in the house.
Oh, we were working on it.
He joins you.
We should turn the basement lights on too, just to make sure.
There isn't a basement in this house.
Oh, good. Turn on the closet light. No dark place.
Roll a perception. Whoever's going around doing such and such.
Henderson's gonna.
It's not rolling.
Do the short range still reach Arthur? We're not that far away.
Yes,
there it is.
Okay, update Arthur that they are inside and safe for the night. Sorry for not getting caught up.
Yeah.
you guys hear me?
Yeah, we hear you.
And my internet is being weird, and it says I lost connection to roll 20.
Oh, no, it said that for me, too.
Yeah.
Okay, never mind.
Could be roll 20 servers,
I think it's backup.
It lagged when I rolled, but it's here.
So, you get a response after a bit, Henderson. It's staticky at first, and you hear,
I have been messaging you for the past 3 hours.
Messaging? Lemon strikes his
phone.
Trying to contact you.
Our radios didn't,
Didn't pick up at all.
Yeah. But we were just out in the town at 4.
Well, I don't know. Maybe with my phone.
Oh, you know that there's been, supernatural creatures have sometimes made static.
Yes, I'm perfectly aware of that.
Or the time hop. It could have been that.
You time hopped? What?
Maybe.
Well, here's what I was going to report. I was checking during the daylight hours. Nat and I were looking at the hole and we found it is not part of the mines. At the bottom of it, there's some man-made structure. It's like a long hallway.
Oh, that sounds distressingly familiar.
I haven't checked where it led, but we lowered a camera down and looked from that.
Henderson just has the idea in his head. He does not vocalize it, but we should get drones. That would solve all of this. Except technology doesn't agree with supernatural stuff, so.
Yep. Gotta go look at it with your own eyeballs.
And now you are all safe in Helling's house for the night.
Hooray. What are the sleeping arrangements?
Well, it'll be interesting considering it's a one-bedroom apartment.
Oh, no.
How many couches and chairs?
There is a living room, a kind of a parlor-ish room, in which both have couches and such. There's a small room upstairs, which looked like it could have been a bedroom, but was converted into an office instead. And then
Did Helling spring for one of the really comfy office chairs?
No, it's just like a litter.
A,
Office Depot, little squeaky.
It's a creaky wooden kitchen chair.
Oh my gosh. Well, his really good chair is at the Cardian's house.
He inherited that chair. Should we type out our perception successes? Sure.
Three. Oh, wait, what? We were doing another success?
Well, we did a... No, we all just rolled perception, but we didn't get... Yeah. Why are you rolling again?
I was testing something for something.
I didn't roll.
Oh. Okay.
I didn't either, so...
It says you guys... Oh, no, that's... Is that
that
your
was
run?
For the yeah. running.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, never mind.
Well, there you go.
Oh,
we have 4, 3, 3, 2, and 1. 4, 3, 2, and 1? Yep. Henderson with 4, Theo and Lemons at 3, Sal at 2, Toma at 1.
I literally have the worst luck with dice.
It's okay, I'm sorry.
Pep's face.
Literally the worst.
I mean... Hopefully we can just hope that it gets better next time.
I'm hoping.
You just gotta sacrifice a goat. That's what I did.
I'm tired of being literally carried by my team.
More dots. Put more dots.
Okay, set dots.
God.
One second. I'm checking something.
I need to check to see how much XP I have. Because I am going to invest in athletics. Oh, I got some good stuff. Yeah.
Good shit.
Gonna get more.
So, you guys look around. You can see outside in the distance a glowing light. And you're glad that that house had nothing around it but woods.
Oh god, is it far enough away from the trees?
It was pretty close to the trees.
Oh no.
How much has it rained?
A lot, actually.
Good.
So... It's more of a smolder, but you do see the light of it over the horizon.
Do we see emergency lights coming through, or is the fire department like, fuck that?
There's no fire department in Carlsville.
Mm-hmm.
So they would have to call from Sturgeon's Bay.
Yep.
You watch it flicker from afar. Henderson, with your 4 successes, you're looking around. Just, like, trying to figure out, oh god, where are we gonna sleep? And you see a little photo frame. Inside of it there is what seems to be Hellings. Oh, a woman that looks strangely... Oh wow, she looks really familiar to your wife. That's strange. A young boy. A little girl. A young boy and a little girl.
Okay.
And they all seem to be smiling pretty happily.
Ah, the good old days.
Little family Hellings.
Pre-Cardians.
When I didn't have to wrangle 2 clubs at the same time.
There wasn't a ton of wrangling going on other than Sal going ahead without permission.
If you guys want to roleplay now, you may. The session is officially over.
Oh, well, yay. I have to go to bed, so...
Ooh.
Like, right now.
Oh. Go sleep.
Okay. Go sleep. That means I'm taking my recording with me, so...
Okay.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Okay.
Oh, wait, XP first. Yes, XP.
Do XP first.
Okay. Okay.
It was
okay.
Great, though. I really loved it.
Yeah. Nice. We got good spooks.
Thank you. I was really excited for this one.
And I was genuinely afraid that we would have had some major damage for Sal and Helen.
If Sal actually is going to get a lot of bonus points for that fire, that was genius.
What?
If you hadn't have gotten so many successes, it wouldn't work nearly as well as it did, but it shut down the entire battle that was supposed to happen.
Oh, would it have just been a... There were so many of them, I didn't think we could have battled them.
Oh, no, it would have been... They would have been taking shots at you while you ran, and it would have done a lot of damage.
Oh, okay. But we still would have been able to, like, run away. That's what happened?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because they don't have the physical mass to exactly hold you down, per se.
They just hurt while they cling.
Yes. They like to hurt organs and stuff.
Cool. So I'd like to point out that this is the kind of flashlight that Henderson bought. I should have skipped ahead a little bit, but it is one that's literally designed to start flashlights.
Oh, really?
Like, you can. Because it's so bright, it's like so high. Well, it's not really designed to, but it's so bright.
It can...
Like, skip ahead to, like, 20 seconds.
That's awesome. What the heck?
Oh, that's sweet.
That's awesome.
Is that what kind of, like, what Sal did?
I think Sal broke it.
He broke it so he could get the light closer.
Yeah. But it's the same kind of deal.
Well, yeah, Sal, you literally shattered yours in order.
Yeah, and you bought a high-powered one, too.
It was an industrial grade, yeah.
Yeah, so you got a really good one.
So essentially you used the spark from that to create a fire.
Mm-hmm.
This is awesome. Oh, okay. Shit. Oh, my God.
All right. That is one hell of a flashlight.
I want that flashlight.
EXP.
Nice.
What the heck? That's awesome.
We've distracted the GM.
Sorry. Okay. Roleplay, everyone gets one for roleplay. Theo, what did you learn?
Anything that is underground is bad.
Okay. Sal, what did you learn?
He needs to kill Omega.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Anderson, what did you learn?
He learned where Hellings' house was.
Yeah.
I like that.
Toma, what did you learn?
Not to touch everything you see, because hands will pop out of walls.
I love it. Nat is not... Why am I giving Nat XP? She's not here. Lemons, what'd you learn?
I learned that some of the monsters, like wisps, that we normally associate with being night creatures, can exist fine enough underground where there is no light.
What am I missing here? Success! Okay. I would say you guys got success.
Did everyone get a success?
Everyone gets success.
I know, but like, I think
that's whether successful mission.
The mission was
not
successful,
not
and then we had one.
No, outstanding action.
Oh.
Sal?
Sal, definitely.
I actually had a ton of crits and stuff.
Sal had so many crits.
Henderson had two?
Lemon's got two. I know one was for running the hell out of there.
I don't think Tomo got any.
Did he do anything worth outstanding action, though?
Got a crit to fuels.
I mean, he kind of saved Sal, but I mean, I don't think that warrants a point.
Well, he used his exceptional success to save one of the people lagging behind, which is pretty impressive for Lemons.
That was Sal, actually.
No, yeah, Sal and Lemons grabbed Theo, Sal grabbed Tomo.
Yeah. Well, Sal is getting outstanding action because he did a fuck ton of stuff this round. Tomo,
you know what? I'm giving Sal 2.
What?
I'm awesome. Down for that.
Yeah,
he deserves it for being ridiculous.
Because Sal hauled ass this go around.
MVP. MVP.
Yeah, I definitely need to do some spending.
He's on fire for more than half the match.
You do have 18 points.
I know, I'm doing some spending because this is a bit ridiculous how I'm getting like ones on everything.
You're just getting really unlucky and I'm really
sorry.
I know.
It makes me really, really upset because I make like, normally this wouldn't happen with my character.
Yeah.
The character would not be getting carried by Helen.
First lane, first street, second lane, second street,
third lane.
Let me tell you a baby story, okay? Here in Milton, there is literally that setup.
Yes. Yeah. I'm not gonna lie, that is an actual street setup.
There's a third lane, a second lane, second street. Yeah, it does that.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. So this is an actual existing street.
Because the streets are wider and the lanes are like meant for like one car. Like width wise, so they're usually thinner.
Alright.
Yay, we did it. I'm going to bed.
Hey.